Very good afternoon to you from the county ground at Derby. It is the last day of the 2009 cricket season on Sky Sports, and it's club cricket's big day out with this, the prize. 2007 saw Totten and Ealing become the champions at Canterbury.
Great shot.
Good caught and bowled.
That's it, it's game over. Totten and Ealing are the winners, and justifiably so.
2008 in Cardiff, and South Northumberland blew away all the opposition.
That's out, and he's got his wicket.
The Cockspur 2020 Cup, the club cricketers, is off to the northeast.
So this year, which one of these four lucky captains will get their hands on the Cockspur Cup? So here we go then with another terrific day of 2020 cricket here on Sky Sports. We're at the county ground in Derby. And this is Club 2020 Finals Day. We've got four sides who fought their way through all season to get to this particular occasion. And of course, one of them will walk away with the Cockspur Cup and an all-expenses trip to Barbados paid for them as well. So that's quite some incentive. Welcome along. It really is always a really good day, this, at the end of the season, as club cricket shows that they can do anything that the pros can do as well. Let's quickly run through the schedule as far as you're concerned, and we're concerned as well. There are four sides here, of course. Bournemouth and Reigate Priory will play in the first semi-final. Then we'll have Cookney from the Notts League against Ockbrook and Borrowash from the Derbyshire League in the second semi-final. And then under the lights here, and it'll get dark quite quickly this evening, I'm sure of that, we will have the final with one of those sides, as I say, at the end of it, getting themselves crowned Cockspur champions in the Club 2020 Cup. Now, what is the Club 2020 competition? Well, let's ask Paul Bedford from the ECB, who joins me once again. Hello, Paul. This is for all the club premierships, is that right?
Yes, it's the 25 Premier Leagues around the country playing off in their own leagues before they get to an area final where they play off against leagues in their area, and a regional final before they get here to Derby.
So it's a pretty big deal to have got this far. You must have come up against some good sides if you're Reigate or Bournemouth.
Yes, certainly. Bournemouth boys have been down to South Wales at Usk. They've been to Bridgewater in North Somerset. Reigate have had to cross the Dartford Tunnel and play in Billericay, and they've all put a fair amount of effort in to get here.
OK, well, it's obviously a terrific day, as I say, for club cricket. The first semi-final is going to get underway very shortly, so let's tell you about the toss to start with. That was won by Chris Murter of Reigate Priory, and he has decided that they're going to have a bowl first, so it'll be Bournemouth to bat. Let's quickly run through the sides. You're not going to know too many of these names. I'm just going to pick out one or two names for you. Bournemouth, let me tell you about them. They're the youngest side in the competition, average age of 20, and their youngest player is David Payne down there at number 10. He's on Gloucestershire's books at the moment, and he played yesterday, actually, an 18-year-old for Gloucestershire against Notts when they blew Notts away for just over 50, and he took 3 for 10. Including Mark Elam in his last outing as a professional cricketer. So he's one to watch when Bournemouth have a bowl. Reigate Priory, now they have got some names which you'll be familiar with. Jason Roy played for Surrey yesterday in the Pro 40. Simon Eccleston, remember him, ex-Somerset all-rounder from the 90s. Chris Murter, Surrey, of course. And Simon King is another Surrey off-spinner with Alex Mendes as well. Now, Mendes is a famous cricketing name. Remember Guillaume Mendes, Lancashire and Sussex? Alex is his nephew, and he's very, very tall, unlike Guillaume. OK, well, we're set to go. The first semi-final is about to get underway, so let's get up to the commentary box. And they're waiting to talk to us and talk through the first phase of this semi-final. John Morris and Dave Fulton.
Thanks, Charles. And it is to be that tall figure of Alex Mendes who's going to kick things off. Right arm fast medium, 24 years of age, cricketing pedigree in the genes. Ian Mendes, I don't think, was much of a bowler. Oh, and some early seam movement with this pink ball and green pitch, John.
Ian Mendes wasn't much of a bowler, I can assure you. He was a very fine batter, though. This young man, well, he's very tall. A bit of bounce here at Derby. There's always a little bit of movement with a new ball. The wicket's quite green, but it will carry through. So it could be quite interesting here.
Wide-ish, got away with the first one. This time it's going to be signalled. There'll be a few nerves here. This is a big occasion for these players. Some talent on show. Could be casting your beady eye over one or two.
I'll certainly be having a look, that is for certain. I think this is fantastic. 2020 competition, four clubs, one day, on the telly. and it's at our ground at Derby, so I think it's absolutely fantastic for cricket. I love it.
There's the dugout. Young side, Bournemouth. Always a bit nervy. Sometimes you're better off in the field when you're kind of young and nervous because you're kind of all together, can feel your way into it.
Yeah, absolutely. It's just nice to get all together and having a run round and making sure that as a team you're bonding straight away and getting ready to go out for a good day's cricket. But sometimes it doesn't quite work that way. You get thrown in and you have to have a bat. So there you go. Get on with it. Tall action, hasn't he, Alex Mendes?
Good away movement as well. Plenty of encouragement from behind the stumps. Mendes getting into his work quite quickly here. Nick Park is an experienced player, 24 years of age. Holds the record for Dorset against Wiltshire, 219 in a minor county match. So he can obviously play, but these are testing conditions, especially in this format when you really want to get on with it. It's nipping around already.
As I said, it will nip around here at Derby, it does. It's that sort of ground, you know. The pitches here have been great all year for us. In 2020 games that we, the pros at Derbyshire had this year, you know, average score was over 150. So there was plenty of carry and plenty of bounce in the pitches, but they always do nibble around early. So it might just do a bit of that this morning, or this lunchtime, I should say.
Play and a miss, and that finishes a pretty decent over. Just the wide from it. Reigate charging round, so this is going to be a tough ask for Bournemouth. Just wondering what their approach is going to be, because they're confronted with a pink ball, a green pitch, decent side. They're going to watch, they're in the power play overs, of course.
And they're a young side as well. Their average age is around 20, so they will be nervous. I think their coach, manager, mentor, whatever you want to call it, was saying earlier that I think the word was terrified that they used. I think the fact that they were on the telly and these young kids, but you know, I hope that they don't freeze on the big occasion. That's important for me. So I just hope that they turn up here today, enjoy their cricket and play to their potential. That's what's got them here. Wide full toss, and it's been hit through the offside. As before, the outfield is very fast here at Derby as well, so away they go.
This will settle the nerves a bit. Mark House, juicy full toss, but he's still got to put them away, and he picked the gap well there. Talking about the Bournemouth coaching staff, settling their men down. I think better than one in the middle of the bat.
Wide.
That's going to be a wide. Reigate looks stronger on paper because they're full of Surrey second team players and a bit of experience with the likes of Alex Richards and Simon Eccleston who played at a decent level. This is Daryl King. This is the, that's not Daryl King. That's the, that could be the coaching staff, do you think? They need to shave if he does, aren't they?
There's a pair of them, so have they got a permit for those to come here at Derby? Well, it's a colourful day here at Derby, that's for certain. Some costumes out, we've got llamas, and we've got some cricket as well with a pink ball, so it's all on here. Talking about this young Bournemouth team, you know, we're saying that hopefully they don't freeze, you know, because they're a young side, but ignorance of youth maybe just comes into it, and they play so freely, they play really well, and I hope that's the case for them. Sure, will be another wide.
Yes, he thought about it, Dean Johnson. It's giving the benefit of the doubt to these bowlers. You don't want to knock their confidence too much by keep widening them. Mark House did have a dabble at that, but pretty wide and swinging further.
Well, it's about discipline as well, isn't it, when you're a bowler and settling into your rhythm as well. And at the moment, a bit all over the place, Mr. King.
That's a better line, that's a beauty. My observation from the first over and a half is that they've just been a touch wide outside off stump. You've got a pitch that is nibbling around. You want to home in on that off stump, get the batsman playing, bring the slips into play.
Absolutely, that's the one thing we talk about, just hit the top of off. And there's absolutely nothing wrong with that in whatever form of the game you want. Just look at that, late movement, off the seam, good carry through to the keeper.
Yeah, it looked like they're trying to pursue this line outside off stump. The umpire's given another wide. That was a partial call, but probably was on the wide side. I just think on wickets that are green and seamy, you want to hit the stumps, threaten the off stump, run in and bowl straight and full. And if there's enough in the wicket, you're asking lots of questions of a batsman's technique. It's better. It's going to get a single for it.
Yes, and that is the perfect line. That brings in the slips.
Yeah.
He only got to hold up a little bit more from there, catch that sort of thin outside edge, and it carries through to the slips. Got two catches in there. If you look here, and that's a great line, just outside off stump. A little bit of swing as well. Bit tighter still, maybe. Just that, attack that off stump.
Darryl King, played a bit of Surrey second team. His brother Simon is on the Surrey staff, young off-spinner. Inside edge, quick single is a mix-up here and it's probably gone to the wrong end. Well, this is going to happen today, lots at stake. Batsman keen to get on with it.
Well, again, it's a full ball and just misses leg stump. Good bit of fielding, but as you say, probably the wrong end. However, it's a long way to throw it off your knees down to the bowler's end, but... What I've gathered straight away in these first two overs, there's an atmosphere out there. Both teams are up for this. You can feel it.
House gets that one down to third man again. Bit of an open back face. Will encourage the slips. 11 without loss. So a decent start for this young Bournemouth side. 11 without loss after two. House has progressed pretty quickly onto six. Boundary to him. Short and wide, and this is going to be signalled wide as well, and that's quite right. Need to settle into their work here, Reigate. He's got all the attributes, Alex Mendes. Swing it out. Tall man. Got to get his line right.
Run. Well played and well run. They look up for it for me, do the Bournemouth team. I said about them freezing because they were young. They've gone at it straight away here. The team, the experience, Reigate, well, they're the one bowling all the wides. Extra balls, they bowl five so far. Nearly another over in 2020 cricket. Well, you know, it's such a tight game anyway. You don't want to be bowling extra balls.
Short and wide, and that got the treatment. No visibility problems with this pink ball. Short and wide, and Nick Park, who's got some pedigree, absolutely climbed into this.
It was short and wide, and it got what it deserved. It's a good shot, waited for it, got his hands free, clattered it over cover. Good shot. I'm liking the look of this Bournemouth side. They're up for it. It's what you need in this competition.
Better line and a really good scampered single. I agree with you, John. Look in the mood, these lads. A bit nervous before the start of the game, but there's nothing wrong with that.
Exactly, and you just look at the support they're getting off the bench. They're all in it together. It's a team. They've come up here as young men and they want to impress. Look at them. They're smiling and ready to go. It's a good day for them, isn't it?
It's a beauty. Just think with Mark House, the way he's shaping up. Hit that four through square cover, and everything else that he's got bat on has gone down to third man. Playing a touch with half a bat.
Yes, he looks as though he favours that offside and tries to run it off through that third man area. These slips could be in business at any stage. Got a ball better at the moment, just a little bit short and wide.
Short and wide again, and he's going to be signalled wide. And at this stage, you can just see the bowler was quite happy with his work. First few, lots of encouragement from behind the stumps. You can almost sense the tension out there. Trying really hard, Alex Mendes. Want to impress. Got the attributes, but struggling at the moment.
And already they bowled another over. This is now a 21-over competition now.
Oh! Perfect. Right back on the money. Bit of a stare for the batsman.
Looked like a Jaffa did that. It's a good action, he's tall, gets it in the right area, he's going to cause problems, as he just has. holds up off the seam a little bit. As I said before, there's always a little bit of movement at Derby. Good carry through to the keeper.
Get!
That's House getting it down to third man again. Favours that area. 20 without loss after three. This is a good start for Bournemouth. Decent crowd in for this Club 2020, the Cockspur Club 2020. I think a lot of it will be friends and family. Lots of local support. Reigate have brought their llamas. Bournemouth have brought bananas. There we go. Some poetry in there somewhere. And the family.
Sure, that's the youngest supporter here today. No doubt about that.
A late swing from Daryl King, and it's going to be signalled wide again. This is a problem for Reigate.
Just wonder whether they might be struggling with this pink ball. The pink ball is swinging around here. And potentially, I suppose, they're not used to playing with this as much, so are they struggling just to control it a little bit? That's seven wides now in the first four overs.
Great shot. Up and over the onside. He's going to get four for it. Steadhouse was about getting the ball down to third man, but he showed here he's a bit more than that. It was a quality stroke.
Yes, it was indeed. And overcompensating there from Mr. King. Sliding it into the pads. It doesn't swing from outside leg stump very often. It just drifts into the pads, carries on that line, and he's picked it up beautifully. Great shot. Right out of the middle of the bat. Hasn't tried to hit it too hard. He's got his hands through it. Controlled. Good cricket shot.
And that's a perfect line of length from Daryl King. This pink ball, a feature of this competition has been how this pink ball has swung. And you want him bowling seam up, you want him swinging it. That's perfect. You could almost have two more slips in there if you bowled every ball there. But just wonder with all these wides, you would be advising from a coach, you know, get it across seam, get it straight, get it down there straight.
Maybe so, just get a feel of it, you know, that first couple of overs. The extras here will add up eventually.
Could be another one, I think. Umpire would love to give the bowler benefit of the doubt. It's a big occasion. He has to be consistent. Daryl King struggling. Goes too straight, he gets whipped for four. He's back outside the off stump with a good one. And then too much width again. Bit of encouragement from his teammates.
Yeah, good to see that. Younger brother coming over. He's patting him on the back, saying, come on, son, you can do this, no problem.
No ball!
Oh, and now we've got a no ball. And that is not what you need. Front foot no ball, and that's going to be a free hit. It's been signalled by Dean Johnson. Mark House might be slightly disappointed. He got a single off that. Always think you get a single when the mate up the other end comes down and can climb into the free hit.
Very true, and also it means they can set the field differently as well. And the fact that it's a new batter, they can move the field around.
Slower ball. Struck it down the ground, didn't really get hold of it, deceived a bit by the slower ball. They're coming back for two, it's going to be tight. Chris Murtagh's a good fielder, one of the best on the Surrey staff. He's just been released by Surrey, but a decent fielder. Captaining today, Chris Murtagh. Interestingly, their overseas player has been their captain, Ian Hewitt. Australian, been a big player for them. 95 he made in the London final, 49 wickets in the league. A misfield, nothing going right for Reigate at the moment. Sometimes that's when you need your senior figures, your captain, him going back, that leadership influence could be a big factor.
Absolutely, you know, the disciplines of the game don't change whether it's in 2020 cricket or in, you know, four-day cricket. You've got to do the basics well. And the fielding part of it is vitally important. And bowling it in good areas, well, in 2020, it's just the most important thing in the game.
It's a bit of length. It's borderline wide again, but some late swing probably saved him that time. Got some good qualities, Daryl King. Looks like he gets it through at reasonable pace, only medium and a bit pace, but got some late swing. He's just got to control it.
Well, there's certainly been swing. That's the thing. You know, we've had this pink ball. We just talked about it. It is moving around in the air and off the pitch. So you can control that swing and you can control that movement. You've got a chance. Four overs gone. That's 31 for none. Alex Mendes to continue. It's probably a wide down the leg side now, so problems mounting here a little bit for Reigate. Disappointing, they are quite an experienced team. That's 10 extra runs, to be honest.
Yeah, I'm looking at the balance of this side, the Reigate side, and I know they've got a couple of off-spinners. They've got another seamer somewhere. Jonathan Gale bowls seam up. It's going to be a wide outside the offside. And Alex Mendes really beginning to feel the heat here. And I just wondered from the captain's point of view, and we talked about Ian Hewitt, the captain, having gone back. Chris Murtagh is now in charge. Just wonder whether you might be inclined, if it's not quite happening, whip him off, get someone else on. Always bring him back a bit later when it's not swinging as much. Up and over, it's uppish, it could be at third man. He's going to go for four.
As I just said, problems are mounting. There's no doubt about that. This is a great start for Bournemouth. They've certainly come out, but they've had the opportunity to hit bad balls, but they've also been fed so many extras now. They're getting the upper hand straight away. So, you know, they're getting control of the game. It's something we talk about in the professional game all the time. You get control, keep control. And unfortunately, at the moment, Bournemouth are miles off the pace with it. Sorry, Reigate are miles off the pace with it.
But the line and length, it's got to be tight. Straight at cover point. And Michael Foster is a good fielder. Michael Foster, Harvey knows him pretty well. Former under-19 Australian skipper. Destined for big things once upon a time. He nearly plucked them all out there.
Just got away with that one. I think we might see a bowling change shortly. I think one of the ex-professional cricketers that's playing for Reigate, Simon Eccleston, he's just at first slip. He's warming up now, so a bit of experience maybe, just time to settle it down a little bit and see if he can use his experience to sort of stem the tide a little bit here.
Good bounce. When he gets it right, Mendes, it's still shortish and wideish outside off stump, but when he gets it right, it looks like it could be a handful. Upper 70s, he's not express pace, but at that height, the bounce, he's getting away movement. He'll just settle down a touch. You can understand why the captain wants to persevere with him.
Well, he should get bounced, there's no doubt about it. He's 6 foot odd. You know, he's a big, tall lad. And again, there's an absolute jaffer. He's got that in the right areas. It's a great delivery.
And if he settled into that spot, he'd be inclined to have two or three slips, even in this format. But too much has been wide. Nick Parker's already chopped a couple over cover point, wide of third man. Oh, this has got to be tight, and there's a misfield. Nothing going right for Reigate. Jonathan Gale misfielding. They get back for a comfortable two. Bournemouth going nicely, 40 without loss. Bournemouth have made a cracking start here on a green top at Derby. 40 without loss, 11 extras. Park 14 from 13, House 15 from 18, and the first bowling change, Simon Eccleston, keeper standing up. Just bowl little medium pace wobblers. Is he going to bowl some tweakers? Oh, I think there was an edge there, that could be down. Simon Eccleston just off a couple of paces, he's got dodgy knees. I remember he retired from the first class game, he's a fine cricketer. Late away swing. Here
we go. Yes, I'm sure there was a nick there, it's a drop chance. Very talented cricketer, Eccles. Had a lot of cricket for Somerset. Always dangerous. Got, I think he got two, three first-class hundreds. He struck the ball very cleanly and bowled as well. Certainly off a shorter run-up than he was then. There's his stats. Look, 46 matches, only 33 wickets, but he was a top cricketer.
Oh! Well bowled. Yeah, he got 140 for Somerset against Kent, a game I remember playing in, and he got 98 as well. Played a part in his dismissal. I was at bat pad, he slog sweat one, it hit me on the shoulder and lobbed to Alan Wells at slip, otherwise he would have had four first class hundreds because that was destined for four. Nearly drilled a hole through me.
I think that's known as a death in the game. But he's shown his experience here, you know, he's only off a couple of paces, but he's bowled straight. He's got a bit of shape on it, taking it away towards that first slip, but he's bowled tighter lines and we've not been able to get away from him now. That's the important thing.
Yeah.
Another single there down to third man. It's a good over so far.
Yeah, Park showing his penchant for the cut. Tension on the dugout. They'll be pleased with their start. A couple of men padded up there. It's up-ish. It's a good shot. And it's going to run away. John Gale is after it, but I think he's going to struggle to pull that up. What a quick outfield here. Power play is up. 45 without loss after six. And the feature has been some slightly errant bowling. Too much width. And Nick Park in particular has climbed into it. Every now and again we've seen what can happen if you get a line and length. But that's been the feature, I'm afraid. Too much wide stuff from Reigate Priory. Those llamas won't be happy.
I don't think the players will be too happy either, to be honest. Never mind the llamas. I think this is part of the issue. You know, these guys are here today to a big, big crowd, if you like. County ground at Derby. Quickest pitch, vast outfield, it's a big occasion, and maybe the nerves are just kicking in a little bit to Reigate. So I think it's great. Absolutely fantastic.
Yeah. Some really good running from Bournemouth, and that would have been out, I think, had it been hit. It wasn't probably the best. Chris Murtagh mentioned earlier, a very fine fielder. Sorry, dragged him around a little bit as 12th man because of this. He has good ability in the field. This would have been out. Out by a yard. Jason Roy is the bowler. He's on Surrey staff as well. Played yesterday in the Pro 40. Bit of a dashing batsman. Probably his strongest suit, but has the experience and the pedigree to bowl decent line and length there. Just 19 years of age. Another sharp single, Murtagh again. And he's not going to miss, keep missing.
Well, what's really good for me is that Bournemouth are putting them under pressure here in the field. They've got the initiative and they keep coming hard here. That's important. Change the bowling. Young Roy's come on. He had a good day yesterday playing against Notts. He's obviously a talented cricketer, but they're not letting him settle. They're putting the pressure on the fielders.
Slower ball. And it was borderline wide. Yeah, the tactic of tip and run's an interesting one, isn't it? Because you are putting the fielders under a lot of pressure and you're saying you've got to be good enough to hit lads.
Yeah.
Absolutely, and that's what they're doing. There's a chance now. Should be out. Oh, he's missed the stumps. Well, when you get opportunities, you've got to take them.
And if you're going to play tip and run, if you hit it, you've got to go. There was a yes, and he was sent back. Understandably sent back, because it was straight at the fielder. It was Eccleston, and he slipped, I think. He got the ball clean enough. But his foot slipped. It is greasy.
Looks like he had a bit of pain there as well. Pulled his groin, maybe. Seems all right, though.
Slower ball chopped away. Just the single this time. No manic running this time. Michael Foster returning over the top of the stumps. 48 without loss. Without loss, Simon Eccleston to continue. Yep. And Bournemouth keep the scoreboard ticking. But an excellent start for this young, inexperienced team. There's a change in the commentary box. Jeremy Coney is with Charles Colville.
Thank you, David.
Yes, Dorsey, come on, bud.
Full toss, they're coming back for two. They're getting it comfortably as well. Keeper's missed another one. This really is a pretty average start by Reigate in the field. They'll be absolutely distraught the way it's gone here because they pride themselves on their ability as a fielding unit, but it's looked very scrappy.
Yep. One's good. Back it up. Back it up.
Five fours, no sixes, so there's been an awful lot of running between the wickets. They've been They've been scurrying the Bournemouth boys.
Just a little untidy, hasn't it, from Reigate? A little bit of width.
Wide. It'll be a wide which will mortify Simon Eccleston. His pace, you'll be reckoning, and he'll know that he shouldn't be slipping down the leg side. Been there, done it all before in a previous life.
And the width, of course, they've offered. Not it was prior to Eccleston's arrival at the crease. Means, of course,
here he goes again.
Yep, extras, and so they are now into 13 and just the eighth over. It's quite damaging, and also it frees the batsman's arms up when it's not a wide. So they've just dragged it down a little bit. The swing, this pink ball, hasn't quite suited them either.
They've bowled 14 wides here, Reigate. That's over two extra overs. Ridiculous in 2020 cricket.
Well, they've used the pink ball now apparently for three rounds, and I guess in practices in between. This pitch is also assisting the bowlers who can get it straight on a goodish length. There's something there for them.
Now, this competition is an ideal opportunity for the authorities to experiment with this new pink ball. It's a fairly garish affair, isn't it? But it's very easy to see that everybody around the world is trying to come up with a ball which is visible when it's just a little bit gloomy, or at night when you're playing day-night cricket, but not use the white one, because the white one, we know, goes grey and green and just difficult to spot. They have to now change it after 34 overs if you're playing 50 over cricket. So everybody's looking for this the new ball, and this pink fluorescent affair is the latest thing to have been given a go. And they're talking, aren't they, about playing one of those test matches next summer between England and Bangladesh, finishing it under lights. So they may well go for this pink ball to play in that game, because they're like in ideal worlds, I'm sure, to play test match cricket in whites, but you can't play with a white ball, so you've got to have something that shows up at night. It'll be interesting later on today to see whether the pink ball works. I hope it does, otherwise we could have a very short final.
Well, it's certainly good to see, there's no doubt about that. There has been, as you can see there, some movement in the air in these first few overs. It's a question of how long does that movement last. And it's also bounced quite nicely. That's more the pitch here. The pitch is fresh. I mean, you want it to last for 120 overs, so there's got to be a little bit of moisture left in it, and overhead conditions today will suit seam bowling.
Again, a bit of bounce. So Jason Roy just pulling it back. This is a decent over so far. He's only gone for one, and he hasn't gone for any extras. 58 without loss. Goodness me.
Nice bounce. And that just shows you, if you can get it there on a goodish line and a goodish length, there's certainly something available. Just need good control. It's one of those surfaces that you allow just natural variation to occur for you by projecting it onto the same stroke rather than doing too much yourself.
Wide. Foster, the fielder, out at deep cover. Michael Foster is an Australian, played a bit of first class cricket for Victoria. He was in the same Australian under-19 team as the likes of Blewett. No ball from Roy. That'll be very costly. Not only has it gone for six, and it's the first six of the day, there's also a free hit coming here.
Roy just dragged this one down. He'd started the over so impressively. Got some bounce, and then no need for the variation, I don't think, because he's done enough with the ball in the right place. just gave the batsman long enough to look at it. Park helped himself. Now he's got another one.
Outrageous slower ball. Good bit of fielding by Roy. Keeper doesn't collect cleanly. And that's really been the story of the day with nine overs gone, 67 without loss so far for Reigate. Their fielding and their disciplines just haven't been up to it.
No, just a bit loose. There's one that's on the square, which sometimes you get a bobble on because it's much harder. There's no real excuse for that. Catch went down with the keeper standing up. Sometimes on these surfaces it's better to stand back until someone runs at you. And you can see just there's missing the stumps. So it hasn't been working for Reigate Priory at the moment. They've really got to tighten their game here. Prospect of a good total if Bournemouth keep going.
Eccleston starting his third over. Two overs for 15. Over 14, and then he's gone for a single already. In the air and over the top of mid on, 2-3-4 bounces, skips away to deep long on for four more, and Bournemouth continue to power on.
Just hits through the middle line, and as the ball swings back, as it just goes outside off stump, there's enough width to encourage House to just hit through that line and gets a good enough contact to get it up and over.
And another four. So this over, which started off with a single, is now worth nine, and we've still got three balls to go. Park on to 28, House 32.
Not so much conviction with that stroke. That's the place you've got to bowl, I think. Don't get put off if that happens. Oh! Got to decide whether the batsman plays a good shot to a loose ball and say, OK, I'm not going to change the field.
In the air again, this time the mid-on has been dropped back, so they're going to get away safely. Oh, and there's a frantic dive. Simon Eccleston decided to see whether it was going to be a direct hit. It wasn't.
Well, it bounced up nicely. The bowler, Eccleston, let it go because he thought it was going to hit the stumps and it needed a dive.
Halfway stage, 10 overs are gone, and with that single, Bournemouth are up to 79 without loss. Bournemouth look like they're heading for a big total, maybe somewhere around about the, well, I don't know, 180 mark, something like that. 140, somewhere between 140 and 180, remember, then the second, oh, a bit of a spread there. All right, Jeremy, calm down. Is it? I was just getting into it, saying about 180, because I thought they'd get 100 off the last 10 overs, and then Coney starts pointing at some random figures on a screen and says 138, so I try and get it right for him, and he starts taking the mickey. Another wide, they're up to 15. Well, how much do you think they're going to get then, Jeremy?
Look at that, though. That's much more important than talking about what they're going to get and speculate. There's nothing speculative there, is there? Nice work. Actually, don't they get rather bad-tempered? Don't they spit at you a bit?
They're not going to spit at us, but they might just take the cameraman's head off. The Llama. They're known as the Llamas, the Reigate Priory. It's their nickname. Okay, I'll go. Brilliant. Three of us sort of around. 81 without loss. Bournemouth are going very well here. But just to sound a cautionary note here before you Reigate Priory off completely.
Yep.
That one's flayed out to deep cover. In the London final against Chingford, Reigate Priory chased 194 and got them four down. In the quarter-final against Henley, Reigate Priory chased 191 and got them two down, with Roy, who's not... Is he bowling now? Yes, he is, still bowling. 138 not out of 60 balls.
Well, I'm not sure whether the pitch in the sort of the Surrey area is going to be quite as green as this one. What this one has done, though, because of the grass on it, which is what I like, it does give extra pace and bit of bounce. So if the bowler doesn't get it right, and we've seen that happen this morning, then the batsman's in with a good chance if he's aggressive and intent.
Yep.
Chopped away. Now, was he over or has he recovered well? That's Daryl King, the fielder. We haven't seen any spin yet. And the umpires are happy with it. So 11 overs gone, 84 without loss. They're just, I think, just going to check about that last one, whether it was four or not. Hugh Evans is the third umpire, having a look at these. Now he gets rid of it there, he's fine. The ball starts to come back. But he's all right because he's kept his feet up. And that would appear to be pretty good fielding. Right, well now, green seaming pitch. The seamers are gone everywhere, so what's the next thing you do? You turn to off spin. And in Simon King, Reigate Priory have got a very promising young off-break bowler. He's on the Surrey staff. He was a winner of the Laker Scholarship a couple of years ago, which was a special scholarship designed to encourage young spinners. Played against John Morris's Derbyshire at Whitgift in a first-class game earlier this season. Played two first-class games against Derbyshire and I think against Middlesex with the other side he played against. Picked up some wickets in both games. Likes to give the ball a bit of air by the look of it.
Boys. Yeah, I thought he got three wickets against Middlesex. I thought he looked pretty good as well. And Surrey then went ahead and an overseas player as an off-spinner for the last two or three games. Didn't seem to make sense to me. However, the young man's in with a chance here today. Yes, he is tossing it up. What Bournemouth have done here as well, they've broken fields up quite quickly in this 20 overs by scoring smartly in the first few overs. They went from 6-3 to 5-4 fields, and so therefore more gaps.
Now a mistake by Roy. Again, this Reigate fielding is, well, at best average.
From Bournemouth, they've played the odd big shot. We know that there are 7-4s and a 6 so far, but they've run very well. The point you were making, Charles, earlier, Sue, they've seized every opportunity. This one just bounces clear.
Another good single.
Great work, bud.
Well taken, well run. 7 from King's first over, 91 without loss after 12. Australia have won the toss. They're batting first, and that is a must-win game for India. Australia can knock out the Indians, which will not be very popular with all the TV schedulers in that part of the world. Just imagine India going out of 2020 World Championship before the final stages. Out of the Champions Trophy early, that really would be disastrous. Right. We have a new bowler on, obviously. This isn't Jason Roy anymore. It's Stuart Hume. One of the more senior members of the side.
Well, he's gone for a couple of boundaries, just over tossing the first ball to go through the offside. Then there's the second delivery. He's just dragged it down a little to compensate, and he's gone through the offside. Wouldn't expect much turn here. 100 up.
Well, Bournemouth are very excited here, aren't they? I think going into this game, Reigate Priory would have fancied themselves as the favourites for the match.
Yes, Doug,
but at
come
the present
on,
moment, Bournemouth are giving them a severe run for their money. Yep. And this partnership between Park and House is brilliant. No doubt about that. Half a chance to the keeper. Park's up to 46, House 41.
Yep.
Chipped away. That's all it is, a little chip. But in fact, it's probably going to race away, is it? No, just good fielding out there by Roy.
What a good stroke that was. Just up and over the man inside the circle and falling well short and to the right of the long on.
Yep.
Oh. 106 without, 107 without loss after 13. Now he's not wearing shorts, House. His trousers are just riding up the back of his legs.
Come on, boys, come on.
Be a chafing problem there if he carries on batting for too long. That was the best over so far, that last one. 16 from it. Here comes King starting his second over. Crisply driven. Another misfield, they don't capitalise this time. Almost as if Reigate Priory are just trying too hard in the field. They haven't relaxed into the game. They're just trying to make something happen, and as a result, silly mistakes are creeping in. Trouble here. Outside is it. It is. So Chris Murta, with his third attempt at a direct hit, succeeds. And that is the end for Park. He's run out for 46. 39 deliveries.
Yeah, on the cusp of 50, he just hit it straight to Murta, who was at shortish mid-wicket, who didn't need the keeper at all to complete the dismissal. So Nick Park gone, good 46, and handed, I suppose, some excitement to the rest of the batting order. It's 108 for one.
Well, the Bournemouth boys are giving Parker a rousing reception as he walks off. He's given certainly Bournemouth a terrific start to their innings. 13 overs and two balls gone, 108 for one. But I was just looking as to what was going on in the Reigate huddle, because they all got together. I was looking for Murta to be reading the riot act to them. There didn't seem to be too much of that going on. You would have thought, though, that it really needed to be done, because if Reigate Priory don't get their act together, this pitch is not going to be a pitch where you can just saunter to 190 for two or three, as they did in the last two rounds. There's something in it for the bowler. You bowl half decently on this and field properly, and you don't give away 15 wides. Life's going to be tricky.
Oh, that's it. That's certainly true. If a seamer gets his act together here today and bowls four good overs.
Here it is, boys.
It's not going to be easy at all.
Put it up on this one.
Right. Nick Park has departed. We've got another Park in. We've got James Park. And guess what? They're brothers. Trainee accountant. It's his third season with Bournemouth.
Come on, lads. I feel
he's very much a Dorset boy, played for every age group from under 11 upwards.
Good finish from King. Able to put together three, four balls. So just the one off the over. That's a much better response from Reigate Priory. Now, just here's the run out. Just no chance to turn on a surface. That's, you need your studs on this sort of surface as well. You can't take your your rubber soles out on that wicket at all. Not suggesting he did have that.
Yep.
Just floating them up, pushing for two here.
Come on, lads.
Rubber soles. Or are we getting Beatles albums in now with your commentary?
Oh. S-O-L-E. But it is, you can see the green nature, even running off the wicket actually is probably even more slippery, I would suggest. So quite a good tactic, I would think, for the non-striker to try and stay as close in as he can.
Yep.
Nice, nice dog.
Look in, no, no.
Easy.
Good, Jay. Good energy, Jay, bowling dogger.
Terrific arm, Jason Roy, hasn't he? Fired that one in from a long way out. It skipped in like an exocet, one bounce and through to the keeper.
You're already slow. Get from that way now. Come on.
So James Park on strike for the first time against Hume.
Get off the wicket!
Off the mark.
As if to underline, you'll see just a little slide there at the non-striker's end that Park unable to take you even look at a second.
Well, we're now at the vital stage of the game for both sides here. Now, Bournemouth have got off to a terrific start at 113 for one, but they've got one more ball of this over and then it's five overs to go. If Reigate get their act together and put together a really good, tight five overs and limit them to, I don't know, 130, 140, something like that, a little bit of a misfield again, then it's not been a total disaster for Reigate. They can still pull it back, but these next five overs have got to be right on the mark, and the fielders have got to help as well. 115 for one after 15.
Well, two attempts to try and tidy up the throw from... They're positioning themselves quite deep in the 30-metre circle, which I guess is understandable because of the run rate of 7.6. What it means, of course, is that it's very hard for a bowler to bowl a dot ball, which is what they require.
House to 50. Well batted indeed. Really good effort that by Mark House. Another one of the young Dorset players in this outfit. He's hit five fours in his 50, which has come off 48 deliveries.
Good stroke from Park. Got to the ball, but was able to get close enough to it that he could angle it through the offside.
Yeah, but Mendes, the fielder, out at deep cover, sweeping up. He looked like one of the llamas going after that.
Yes, there it is.
Well, that's gone. So that is the end of James Park for five. Simon King gets the wicket.
Second wicket for King, and the bottom hand came into play. He needed to get more involved in that, and Eccleston looks to me as it there at short fine. So he picks up a second wicket, and 118 for two.
Now, you see, this is, for me, where the game is won and lost here, because Bournemouth, having had this terrific platform and got this great start, can now blow it all by trying to be too ambitious. And they can try and whack at everything. And if they lose a little cluster of wickets here, then all of a sudden, Reigate are back in it. And Bournemouth will find they've only got 140 on the board at the end of their 20 overs.
Yes, they have to continue to be aggressive, but they must be determined not to have an indiscretion. In other words, every batsman looks to stay at the crease, but looks to get as many runs as they can from each delivery. use the full face of the bat so that the risk factor lies and resides with you as a batsman rather than the bowler and the fielding side.
Simon Watkins is the new batsman, left-hander. He's currently a student up at Oxford Brookes University and is a member of the Oxford University Centre of Cricketing Excellence.
Catch it.
In the air, it's going to be safe though, it's going to land safely. It's just a little chip shot and they're going to get back for, well, they are going to get back for two, although they probably could have done. They'd spotted the misfield. Well, that's a much better over there for the Reigate Priory boys. 120 for two after 16. Five runs from the over. But a really fine 50 for House. He's got to a 50 of just 48 deliveries, including five fours. Great range of strokes. Lots of scurrying between the wickets as well. Five fours, yes, but lots of ones and twos, and really has put the pressure on the Reigate fielders who haven't actually stood up to it that well. So, four overs to go. It's 120 for two. We'll have a change in the commentary box now.
Right, left hand.
As Ian Harvey joins David Full.
Left hand, doggy dog. There you go.
Come in, come over. Come on over. Can you hear?
Thank you, Charles.
Yes, there is.
What can Simon Watkins do? Powerfully built, left-handed batter. Top order have laid a good platform for him. Nice looking cut shot, just the single for it.
Yeah, not for the first time. Hume's been a little bit expensive, but King, three overs, one for 13. Not the first time we've seen the spinners put the brakes on in 2020 cricket. Doing a good job.
Pulled away from House. There's a fielding cover down there on the deep mid-wicket fence. Be another single. Stuart Hume, the veteran, former Kent League player, Kent Cricket Board player. My vintage, played against him a few times. Steady off spinner normally. Good looking strike from Watkins. But Hume bowling to his foot. Gonna come back for two. It's been a real feature, the running. Gonna have to scurry. And they get there.
Yeah, excellent running from House. He's been, this is one of his highlights of his innings. His running between the wickets. And he runs the first one extremely hard. He comes back. What's the fielding side under pressure?
Pulled this away. Simon Watkins just to long on. Probably the single. Just feel Reigate have really missed a trick here. Early on, conditions were very favourable for seam bowling. They couldn't get it right. Not much in this pitch for these spinners, as much as they're doing a decent job. It's up in the air. This could be out. Has he picked the gap? I think he has. Going to come back for two. Murtagh couldn't get there. Reigate still looking a little untidy in the field. 128 for two. Cockspur Club 2020. First semi-final between Bournemouth and Reigate Priory. 541 sides entered this competition. We're down to four. In a short while, we'll be down to three. At the moment, you'd probably have your money on Bournemouth. This is looking a pretty imposing total, with three to go. I think they could get up 150 plus, which on a green top, tough to chase down.
This one,
powerful
Jay,
shot from Watkins.
Yeah, good one. Quality, Jay, backers.
Yeah, it then comes down to the bowlers, doesn't it? I mean, we did see the Reigate side really struggle with the new ball, the pink ball. But we have seen them as well in the past. Their last few games have chased 190. Doesn't look like the Bournemouth side are going to get anywhere near that. So especially after the way they started, probably Bournemouth at the moment would be the happier of the two teams.
which is going to be a single. They have been quick between the wickets, but Simon Watkins intent on the strike. Jason Roy doing the fielding. Simon King the off-spinner. Jason Roy down at long on. A Surrey second team combination. Similar hairdos. Similar kind of image. House will want two. He's been running for these all day and he's coming back. It's going to be tight. He gets there again, you know. King the younger, Darrell, at long on. And with that kind of throw, you want one bounce over the top of the stumps, whip the bails off. You don't want the ball bouncing 2 yards in front of you as a bowler.
Come on! Just the one this time.
Yeah, it's not easy under pressure, is it? 2020, quick game. Batsman putting pressure on the fielders. They have done it well, the Bournemouth side. Ran well between the wickets. Really constantly putting the fielders under pressure.
Catch it. Pick the gap there, I think. That's a cracking shot. That's the first boundary since the 13th over when Stuart Hume went for 3 fours off his first three deliveries. They've scampered in the meantime. Mark House opening the shoulders.
Yeah, House moves on to 60 now, and that's a fantastic shot. Not trying to overhit the ball. Picked his areas where he wanted to go. No fielders out there. And Michael Foster had no chance of getting around to cut that off.
And the wicket is going to look for two, but this time Chris Murtagh has got his paws on it. They won't take two to him. Probably the best fielder on show. 138 for two. Two overs to go. What do you think they're going to get here, Ian, if you had to put your money on it?
Two overs to go. I think they'd be looking at trying to get around 160, I think they'll be hoping for. But I mean, they were hoping 10 overs ago, halfway, they would have been looking at around 170, maybe even 180. But might have to settle for around the 160. If they could get there, they'll feel that they have got a decent target on the board.
Jason Roy back into the attack. Simon King finished, decent figures. 1 for 23 from his four. Surrey colleague Roy, young firebrand of a cricketer, very talented, passionate about his cricket. Yet another wide. That's what happened early on. You'll see the funny side. Roger. 14 individual wides. It's more than two overs. Gifted. That's going to be a wide as well. When he's to settle into his work. His batting is his strongest suit. And I would say on paper, Reigate, looking at the pros and the former pros, you'd say their batting is stronger than their bowling. But left themselves a tough ask here.
Yeah, we did hear Chris Murtagh say at the start of the show that he felt that because they've chased down a lot of totals, their batting is probably the stronger suit.
They might not get a chance to have a bat at this rate. Three extra overs bowled by Reigate. 16 wides, two no balls. Very profligate. Jason Roy, the smile after the first one has been replaced by a look of angst. Is he going to get through this over? Hold it across the seam, young man, and get it down there. Decent stop by Stuart Hume. Yard either side, and that would have been four. Roy completes the legitimate delivery.
Yeah, not easy at this end of the innings. You've got to try and hold your nerve, the change of pace, try and get it as full as possible up in that block hole, not allowing the batsman to get underneath it.
It's gone high, and it could be six. It's a maximum, the ropes are in, and he's cleared them.
Yeah, good catch for Michael Foster out there, but it was just on the wrong side of the rope. Again, backs, as we were mentioning, trying to get it as full as possible and not allowing the batsman to get underneath it. So they've got a length ball. And Watkins has really helped it on his way. Big, strong lad. Turning out to be an expensive over.
Oh, I think he might have got a bit of a bottom edge on that. No. He signalled another wide. I do think there was a little nicky noise. He might have been a touch unlucky there. Jason Roy. Let's have another look.
No, I think that's a wide. Really losing his way here. Four balls remaining in this over, 11 runs as well. Not going his way at the moment.
Balls could be run out sharp and Roy misses. It's not quite happening for the young man. Better delivery. And he is a talented young cricketer. I guess this is a great learning curve for him. If he's going to make his way in the professional game, he's going to have to be in front of the television cameras and with crowds watching. That would have been tight had he hit. But a nervy occasion.
Yeah, it certainly is. It's nervy at the best of times in cricket, bowling at this stage of the game. You've got batsmen trying to hit every ball you bowl out of the park. It's even worse. So needs to hold his nerve here.
Well struck. It's another six. Watkins on fire at the back end of this innings.
That brings up the 150. And once again, a length ball is dispatched over the boundary. I was saying 160. It looks like now they'll be going to maybe getting in the region of 170. Just if they keep bowling length balls.
Well, he's a man after your own heart here, Ian. Not only does he like to look, like to hit big, but his superstition is that he doesn't go to bed before midnight on the day before a game. So he enjoys himself on and off the pitch by the look of it.
A lot better delivery. Full and just outside off stump. That's where he's just got to learn, try and keep the ball out there. Not really allowing the batsman to get underneath it. That's a lot better delivery. One legitimate ball remaining in this over. 17 runs from it.
Nice comeback from Jason Roy. Credit to the young man there. Showed plenty of character. There's a few wides and a couple of sixes in that over, but he finished strongly.
Yeah, he's finished his four overs. None for 36. 17 off that last over, 18 runs, sorry, coming off that last over. Here's the batting card. Great start from Park and House. Hey, Park, he went early.
Alex Mendes coming back into the attack. That's just an interesting point. I hope it's interesting. Now I've built it up, but got an hour and 15 to bowl these 20 overs, and they have bowled three extra overs in extras, and yet they've still got 12 minutes to complete this last over. So they've done pretty well. They've hurried between the overs. They got through the overs. Perhaps they could have taken a bit more time, a bit more composure. Might have helped with some of those extras.
Keep up! Coming back for two. It's going to be tight. Oh. Not a great throw again, and the keeper unable to take the ball. Too happy. Just needed a clean take. Feel that may have been out. Yeah, just bounced a bit. Didn't have the ball. Just needed a clean take.
You just wonder if Reigate are going to rule these chances in the field. Good mix-up from Alex Mendes. Sometimes I think at this stage of the innings, you'd expect him to go full and straight, but at his height, back of a length, not an easy length to hit.
Yeah, Alex Mendes, he was running back to his mark there. He's still got a lot of time, so it was a valid point, though. Maybe they've rushed it a bit today.
That's up, and this could be out. It's not an easy chance. It's a brilliant catch. Alex Richards. Tremendous catch going back over his shoulder. An outstretched paw, and he reeled it in.
That's exactly what they needed. Maybe going in a bit of a high, dug in short from Mendes. High on the bat, and that's a fantastic catch. Simon Watkins is on his way. A useful 24, it's 158 for three.
Well, Reigate Priory supporters, they have something to cheer at last. Alex Richards, tremendous catch. Craig de Weijman is the new batsman. Alex Richards, a man who was amazing myself. I played England schools with Alex Richards. He was our captain. Decent cricketer. Used to bowl off breaks in those days. I don't know what's happened to those. Probably more of a batsman. Success for Mendes at last. Looked full of promise when he started. It was just a bit wide outside off stump. Got one at last. Nice looking shot from House. Continues to impress the young man. Going to scamper back for two. And again, it's sloppy work in the field from Reigate.
Yeah, the thing they have done is they've pushed hard the Bournemouth batters. And de Weijman coming in, trying to get House back on strike. Ran the first one hard. All it took was a little bit of a fumble in the deep. Come back for an easy two.
Look for two, but they're just going to get the one. Yeah, I think as much as we, Reigate, haven't been at their sharpest in the field, you've got to give a lot of credit to these batters. They put them under such pressure. There's a lot at stake. Mark House scored 71 in the regional final against Mokdra, Bournemouth's leading scorer in the competition, continuing where he left off with that one. Craig de Weijman, what can he do?
Yes.
Yeah, captain of the Bournemouth side. Be very happy coming in. This stage of the game. One ball remaining. So it's pretty much a free hit, isn't it, really, for the captain?
Yeah, I used to hate those situations. See my off pole cartwheeling back because I essayed something a bit expansive. Mendes get himself another wicket here. Big shout. Going to get a leg by. They're going to come back for two, I would think. Taking him on. Surely he's got to go. Gone this time. Tidier work from Reigate. And at last they get something right in the field. Stuart Hume with the throw. Matt Bennett whips them off. But had to go for it, the captain.
Yeah, selfless cricket. From de Weijman, the captain, coming back for two. Not sure who's out there, really. But no, actually trying to come back for two. This on this occasion, excellent fielding. Keeper takes it cleanly.
Well, the crowd have enjoyed it. There's been plenty of action. Mark House, a fine knock, 65, not out. Terrific innings from him, and as much as Reigate were profligate with the ball early doors and their fielding wasn't quite as sharp as they would like. They got a lot of batting, so don't write them off. It's the story of the innings. Nick Park with 46 and Mark House at the top of the order. 65 not out after 58. Jamie Park just with five. And then Watkins, a powerfully struck 24. And the captain, Craig de Weijman, was run out by Stuart Hume for one. 162 for four. Looks a pretty impressive total.
Yeah, things didn't really go the way of the bowlers today. A few expensive economy rates there. Few wayward deliveries early with the new ball, but for me, the pick of the bowlers down the bottom there, the spinner, Simon King, one for 23 off his four overs.
So that's the story of the game so far. 162 for four. Jeremy Coney's got Mark House with him.
Yeah, thanks, Dave. Yes, I do have Mark with me. Well played. That was a good start.
Yeah, thanks. It's more than we were expecting. We're looking at a target of about 140, so I think we're well in it here. So.
How did you find the pitch?
Yeah, I thought it did a little bit. There's a bit of pop, it's a bit skiddy, so Yeah, I think our bowlers will bowl well on it.
And quick enough that you can play a wide range of strokes?
Yeah, definitely, yeah.
And what about the pink ball? Did that move a bit at the early doors?
A little bit. There's a bit of swing to start with, so yeah, it was good.
And this total, you say 160, you feel reasonably happy with that?
We're definitely happy with that. It's over what we're expecting, so.
Go and have a bit of rest. Good luck. Cheers.
Thanks, guys.
There we are. Well, didn't he bat well, young House? He made 65 not out. He held the innings together, and he's got the Bournemouth boys up to a pretty reasonable total. What's your sort of average when Derbyshire were playing here in 2020 cricket? What was your sort of scores?
150, 160. So
all right, so they're right thereabouts. And I would think probably this is a bit greener. Well, maybe not a bit greener than what you'd normally play on.
It is a lot greener than we played our 2020 cricket games on. Our 2020 wickets were flat. This has done a bit, so I think it's a really good score, this.
Well, it'll be fascinating to see exactly how this all turns out now, of course, because remember, Reigate say that their strength is their batting. They've got the prolific Roy, you've got that 100 off 60-odd deliveries in the last round, they've got Murta, they've got Eccleston, former Somerset batsman. Batting is their suit, but they have given Bournemouth an awfully large total, and they've given it to them, basically, haven't they?
Well, they have given it to them. I think they were undisciplined with the ball, they were undisciplined in the field. They're running between the wickets that Bournemouth did, put them under pressure, and kept the pressure on them right the way from the outset. And I think all the pressure went onto the bowlers. The wicket did a bit. This pink ball swung around, it nibbled around off the seam. Having said that, they batted brilliantly on it. They took advantage of it and they put a total on the board. I think it'll be really difficult for them to get.
OK, we're going to take a very quick break now. When we come back, we'll prepare for the second half and we'll consider what has happened so far. It appears to be advantage Bournemouth, but we shall see. See you in a moment. Well, first semi-final, halfway stage in the Cockspur 2020 Cup between Bournemouth and Reigate Priory. And Bournemouth appear to have got a pretty formidable total on the board, 162 for four in their 20 overs, with Mark House 65 not out. He and Park added over 100 for the first wicket, and then they powered on to 162 for four, although Reigate did help them by bowling no less than 17 wides. That's basically three extra overs, so they've basically bowled 23 overs here, and it's no surprise that they got out at 164, because you take those runs off and the extra runs are on the extra balls and everything's a bit more manageable.
Well, absolutely, as I said, just 162 is a lot of runs here, especially on this wicket. The disciplines of the game in 2020 cricket are vital. You've got to do the simple things well. Don't give the opposition extra balls, don't bowl extra overs that you don't need to bowl, and if you do the simple things well, you keep control of the game, and they haven't done that, so that's why they've got 162.
And Reigate, of course, were just, well, they were a bit nervous in the field, weren't they? This is the bowling, these are the wides that are coming up, and the fielding was just, every now and again, it was almost as if they were trying too hard, and things just kept going wrong for them.
We said I was first on commentary, and then we said about the nervousness that might be in the Bournemouth camp because they're a young team. It seemed to be the other way around, and the pressure certainly went on to Reigate right from the outset, and it was endemic right the way through their innings, really.
He won't like me for saying this, Chris Adams, but to Reigate Priory are obviously a Surrey club, and I thought this performance was pretty indicative of what Surrey cricket has been going through all season, actually. It was just sort of off the pace.
Look, I don't even know where Reigate is. Where is it?
Just the jewel of the North Downs. Just right. Junction 8 on the M25. It's lovely, okay. Lovely town. Okay.
Well, yeah. Surrey cricket, Surrey cricket. And they've been a big club, as we know, and Chris Adams is a great mate of mine. I played here with him at Derbyshire. And, they've not had the best of years, but I'm sure he'll get it right for them.
Right, OK, let's just talk about somebody from Bournemouth who did really well, Mark House, who made a 65 not out. What did you make of this young man?
I thought he played well. That was, his first ball of the second over and went for four. And from that moment on, his confidence grew. He played some great shots. He kept control, as we said, batted through the innings and played some beautiful cricket shots. And he wasn't trying to hit the ball too hard. They're not massive hits. He's just picked his gaps and played some really good cricket shots. So, I'm really pleased that these lads get this opportunity. Fantastic arena to come and play on TV, four clubs, winner takes all. Go to the Rumsey Travel Pro-Am in Barbados at the end of it. How fantastic is that?
Right, well, let's concentrate and see exactly how Reigate are going to go about getting these runs. They have a history, if you like, of chasing down big totals. They've got 190 in both of their last two rounds of this competition. The only thing is, And who knows, we weren't in Chingford and we weren't in Henley. I don't expect it was as green as this surface that you've prepared for them here in Derby.
I don't think the wickets down in Reigate are quite the same as we have here in Derby. That would be my guess. But listen, if they get them, they've played well and good luck to them.
But I mean, the thing is, it's coming on. The ball's coming on. It just will, if you get it in the right place, it'll nibble around. And the interesting thing, and I suspect the biggest threat here for Reigate Priory, is the young lad from Bournemouth, David Payne, who's on the Gloucestershire books, played yesterday and took 3 for 10 against Notts for Gloucestershire, ended the Elam career with a duck. He will be the threat.
Well, there's young players up and down the country that want to make the mark, and he's obviously had a chance there with Gloucestershire, and he's got a chance here today again to show us what he's about. So I'm looking forward to this chase now. The wicket here will do a bit right the way throughout the day. There's no doubt about that. If they get the ball in the good areas, it'll cause batters problems.
Absolutely. OK, well, everybody's getting themselves ready. I think probably from the point of view of Reigate Priory, the batsmen you want to watch are Jason Roy. You've got 138 off 68... deliveries or so in the last round. Here is David Payne, the left arm fast medium 18-year-old, only 18. He's already played county cricket, and here he is now with a terrific opportunity, if he gets the ball right and he gets all his disciplines right, to put Bournemouth through to the final against, in case you haven't been with us right from the off, the other two sides, Cuckney and Ockbrook and Borowash. Let's get over now and join Jeremy Coney and David Fulton.
Thanks, Charles. David Payne looking to exploit. Still a bit of moisture in this pitch. A bit of early swing as well. Leg by to Jason Roy. They won't come back for two. Young side, this Bournemouth side, and they would have settled into their work in the first half of the game. Reigate was so nervous, understandably. A lot at stake here. A bit nervous. They were a bit errant with the ball and a bit slack in the field by their normal standards. Simon Eccleston, experienced campaigner. Played against him for a number of years. He was down at Somerset. Very powerful ball striker. Saw him with his little medium paces, but he's a batter really. And he can hit a very long ball.
First thing Bournemouth have to do here, after using the bat quite efficiently, hit him on the outside, is not to really repeat the errors of the ways, I think, from Reigate. To bowl 19 extra deliveries, 3 extra overs in a 20-over match, that's quite significant. So the main thing is target it on the stumps and just outside, try and get it onto a goodish length, and allow this new ball. We saw it swing just a little, we saw it just nip about, and that's really, I think, the approach that bowlers should take with the new ball here on this surface.
Beauty from David Payne, and this is what he's capable of. You saw him take 3 wickets yesterday for Gloucestershire against Notts. It's just come from Trent Bridge, which I guess helps him in that he's been in a big arena, a test match arena. That's a beauty. You're not getting a bat on that. You could have 20 goes at that and you miss on every occasion. It's gone sideways off the seam. Almost like to see a second slip in, really. They've got a short extra cover. It's almost a 2 or 3 slip job here. Another play and a miss from Eccleston. 3 strikes and you're out at baseball, but he's got away with the 3 play and misses here. But I think if David Payne's been at Trent Bridge playing in the first-class arena, he's going to settle into his work more easily than someone like an Alex Mendes, for whom this would be a huge occasion.
He'll be more comfortable, there's no doubt about that. And the fact, the confidence he can draw from that higher-class fixture must help him here. I agree with the 2 slips. If you're against a side that are quite dangerous, and we've heard some of the totals that Reigate Priory have chased down, and some of them are 190. I know the surfaces will be different, but 190 and 170, so this is not within their sort of compass to chase. But at the same time, the ball is doing enough. I think let's get rid of the top order if they do provide us with a chance.
And that is what Simon Eccleston is all about. Meaty blows, and he's got a bit of width on this occasion, and he has smashed that. That wasn't far off a 6, you know. Powerful man.
Yeah, clouted forcefully. As you can see the determination from the backlift and then bringing it down through the hitting area. 1 bounce. Can't give the width. There's a clear message.
Really strong through the air. the offside, Eccleston. Big cover driver, and he'll lay back and slash anything with a bit of width. Jason Roy, he's a powerful cricketer as well, 138 from 60 balls. So that kind of strike rate. They could, if the bowling's not too clever, make mincemeat of this total. You just think if they can settle into a line and length, get a bit of moisture, exploit the moisture in this pitch and the tinge of green, it's going to be difficult. Ed Denham, my partner David Payne. Right arm, medium fast, just 19. Young side, this Bournemouth side, but they look confident. Big wind up at that, Roy. It's gone down to third man. It's just going to be the single. One of the things you'll see between the wickets here is that Eccleston won't be the quickest. He's had a lot of knee problems in his career. Had to retire early because of his dodgy knees. That's why he trots in off two paces when he bowls. Alston, an early end to a very promising first-class career.
Sort of batsman, I think, once you've had a look at him for an over, as a fielder in the circle, you say, I'm going to push myself to the edge. I'm not really going to be homing in to save those short singles. Because if that's what you're saying is true, then you've always still got a chance, even though you position yourself on the edge. Looks like no slips here and just two either side.
A wicked touch there, Eccleston. So that's a good length. You know that the batsman's going to come pretty hard at you here. These first six overs, the power play over, so I totally agree with you. Mid-on, mid-off on the circle, they can drop deep. Eccleston's not going to take quick singles, but he will play shots like that. But I just think you can still just hit a length and trust that the pitch is going to do enough so he won't be able to consistently hit you off your length. Got away with that one, Denham. You've got to guard against going full at this situation. You might think, oh, we'll try and get a few in the block hole. But I'd be more inclined, if I was his captain, to say, just hit a length, let the ball, let the pitch do the work. You go block hole and you don't get it right, to someone like an Eccleston, he can destroy you. Big wind-up at that one. He's got it through. It wasn't a bad delivery. It was a bit agricultural. He is a farmer these days, Simon Eccleston. He's got it away to the boundary.
Yeah, plenty of earthy nature, wasn't there? Something rustic about this stroke. And you get the feeling straight away that Eccleston's going to try and bully the Bournemouth attack here. He's going to try and go hard at them and play some big flowing strokes. Could be interesting.
Gone up and over again. Didn't get all of this, Eccleston. Probably only got a couple for it, although it's quick, this boundary. Good bit of work. He's going to come back for three. Good stuff from Bournemouth in the field. Simon Ridley. Good work. Just flicked it back. Oh, that's come back sharply. But I think he might be outside the line. Good decision. Nip back like an off cutter. What do you make of this one, Jeremy?
Well, I thought originally they were looking as if they were appealing for a catch behind. It did nip back. There's no doubt. And there's the value of bowling the length. But it's certainly coming back in, isn't it, towards and threatening that off stump. Yes, it's going to hit off stump. He just gets outside the line. Just.
Was just, wasn't it? Where he finished up wasn't exactly where it hit him. Lap of the pad was just millimetres outside the line of off stump. I think it was a really good decision. But it was certainly just coming back quickly enough to clatter into off stump. So Jason Roy, touch of fortune there, but already signs that Bournemouth are going to hit a bit of line and length. A lovely looking shot from Eccleston. They'll take the single. Thank you. Reigate Priory Cricket Club, known as the Llamas. Kent Spitfires, the Sussex Sharks, the Reigate Llamas. Felt they needed a name, and they've even brought the Llamas with. Full toss, slower ball, 68 miles an hour. Good change down from David Payne. There they are, the Llamas. Bowling and fielding coaches, I think. Might have a bit to say at the end of this match if they do manage to sneak through ahead of the final. Good shot from Eccleston, done by a change of pace again, 69 miles an hour, but he's hit it one-handed and hit it straight down the ground, an indication of how quick this outfield is and how strong Simon Eccleston is. One-handed, come four.
Very eager to attack, Eccleston. He got an opportunity there with a slowish full toss. I just wonder whether he's starting to affect the younger players a bit here, the way he's playing so aggressively at them.
And that is going to go for four wides, I would think. Down the leg side, no chance for Chris Ridley. David Payne. County pedigree, three wickets yesterday at Trent Bridge as they dismantled Nottinghamshire for just 57. This wasn't his best bit of work, and I think you're right, the way Simon Eccleston's shaped up, just in his body language and the way that he's looked to put back to ball, he's already got these bowlers thinking quite hard.
Yeah, it is an unnerving thing too, to know you're bowling to a player who's just all out interested in attack, and it's a goodish total they've got behind them. This is a good move from Reigate Priory.
He's launched into that one. There's a man back on the deep cover fence, good field placing. Craig de Veerman, the captain. David Payne has the pedigree to be able to bowl to this field. Strike rate of above 140. This is what Eccleston will be about. Top of the order, field up, hit it hard. It's a beauty from Payne, 25 without loss. Good start for Reigate Priory. They need 163. Another 138 runs to win. Over eight and over. Made a good start here. Hasn't got all of that, Eccleston, and won't get a run for it. Ed Denham's just mixed his pace up. Self-deprecating fella, Ed Denham. A couple of claims to fame this season. He was given timed out during a Southern League game. Timed out, you don't see that too often. And he got a pair, and he's, Nick Park got a double 100. Good strike, but he's been called at mid-off. Reeled in by Ridley, Chris Ridley. Simon Ridley with a catch, rather, and Simon Eccleston goes. That's a big wicket. Bournemouth know it.
Well, a rebel against stale custom, isn't he? Eccleston, he wanted to go up and over and continue this process of trying to bully the younger Bournemouth attack, but really just in or far back enough in the circle. Tall lad was able to take the catch two-handed. So Eccleston, the dangerous Eccleston, gone for 17, 25 for one.
Chris Murtagh, the new batsman. Down the wicket, first ball. Still plenty in this track. Ed Denham, 74 miles an hour, but it left the batsman and bounced.
Yeah, just a touch of the I'm going to go after you, and a sort of a cross sort of blade, if you like, as he launched into it. didn't get all of it, and so Ridley took the catch.
I just wonder whether they can have a slip in here. Ed Denham just settling into his work. His bounce, there's a little bit of away movement. They got a short extra cover and a short mid wicket on a pitch which has got pace and carry and a little bit of away movement. Could easily nick that through there.
Yeah, don't think they need both at all. The ball, if anything, is sliding on, so it's not going to be a case, especially when it's new. So I don't feel it's a case of players mistiming drives from a ball that stays on the surface a little longer. So you mistime it, more likely to get an edge. It's a better percentage.
I guess this is, you're playing on a county ground with more pace and bounce and a bit more grass on the wicket than they'd be used to. Sometimes on club wickets, the ball stops a bit more. That's a great looking shot. Chris Murtagh down the pitch and launches him straight for a maximum.
This is a good stroke. He missed the first one. He had enough room on this to swing the arms freely, but he's played a conventional cricket stroke. Got all of it.
Well, what a shot that was, Chris Murtagh. 31 for one. And we've got a slight change in the commentary box. I'm going to hang in here, but just to talk about his brother and that monumental shot. He's Tim Murtagh, formerly Surrey, Middlesex fame these days, of course. I didn't know he could play shots like that, the little brother.
I didn't either. I've seen it in the back garden a few times, but not so much on the out on the pitch itself.
Now, what's all this about you not registering for Reigate Priory? I presume these used to be your boys, did they?
Yes, they did. Yeah, I played for them for 4 or 5 years. Haven't played for a couple of years. Sort of being in the Middlesex and Surrey first team hadn't allowed much opportunity. But I didn't actually get around to registering for them this year. So missed out on the competition, unfortunately.
It's gone fine. It's just going to be the single. Run away too quickly. Yeah, I don't know what you made of the opening attack from Alex Mendes and Daryl King. It just looked a little bit nervous. You're probably closer to them. You maybe tell us about their kind of state of mind or whatever, but there was certainly enough in the pitch. You would have, I think, been a handful on here, mate.
Yeah, they did look a bit nervous. Obviously, you know, it's a big day for them. It's a big day for the club. Unfortunately, they bowled a few wides. You know, perhaps they're not used to the pink ball either. It seemed that the pink ball did quite a bit.
A cracking shot. Murtagh launched one for six straight, and he's shown he's pretty adept off the back foot as well. He's on fire.
Yeah, nice looking shot, this one. Looks as though he's in pretty good touch. Ever since he's been released, he's actually played pretty well for Reigate and scored a lot of runs. Perhaps it's been a bit of pressure off his shoulders, and hopefully he can lead the Llamas to victory today.
Leading the Llamas. It's a beauty from Payne. Bit of ability, this young man. Yeah, interesting you mentioned about the kind of pressure off with him being released, because I know he was in the second team for quite a long time and always trying to force his way into the team. And you can put unnecessary pressure on yourself. Suddenly you get released, you're playing back at your club, and he's already shown a couple of high-quality shots.
He has, yeah. He's sort of back playing with his mates now. You know, there was a lot of pressure at Surrey. He's a pretty nervous starter as it is, no matter what game he's playing.
Another nice looking shot, intercepted by extra cover.
You know, he had a few opportunities at Surrey. He'll probably say not as many as he would have liked. But he didn't take those opportunities, and yeah, unfortunately got the bad news about three quarters of the way through the summer that they weren't renewing his contract. I probably didn't help that by getting him out in a Pro 40 game at Guildford.
Another good delivery from Payne. 36 for one. ...127 more runs to win for Reigate Priory. 90 balls, that's approaching 8.5. It's still manageable at this stage because they've shown they've got the batting, they've chased down some big scores in this competition. They do have 9 wickets remaining. They want to make the most of this remaining over of power play. Have you spoken to them at the halfway stage? Are they disappointed with their fielding and bowling effort?
I did, yeah, they were pretty disappointed. Had a word with Neil Saker, their bowling coach, who used to be at Surrey. Got stuck into him for the amount of wides that they conceded as well. I think they were pretty disappointed. I think they thought more 140.
It's a great looking shot. He's absolutely nailed that, but he's picked out the man on the deep cover fence. Bournemouth have looked sprightly in the field. Much more clinical than the Reigate boys at this stage.
Yeah, I think they probably thought sort of 140 was about an average kind of par score. Obviously those 20 odd extras or whatever they conceded, you know, probably took that score to, you know, an above par score.
Down the wicket again, and he's picked the gap. And he's going to get 4 for it. Chris Murtagh, even when they come out the outside edge, he finds the gaps. How could Surrey let him go?
Looked like a bit of fielding from his older brother there as well. Went in with the feet. He's taken the positive route here, and it's, you know, come off for him. And I think these two are going to have to score most of the runs. Jason Roy's a good striker of the ball, and Murta with a bit of experience as well. So I think these two will have to take him close.
Another good-looking shot. Half stop by the bowler enables them to get through for a quick single. That was the other feature of the Bournemouth innings, how well they ran between the wickets. At touch, it was a bit kamikaze, but they made their mind up to put you guys under pressure, and it paid off for them by and large.
They did. You know, they put the pressure onto us, and we kind of crumbled a little bit in the field, especially in the outfield.
Straight, high on the bat, didn't get hold of it, but he's got enough of it. Going to go for 4. It's a strong shot from Jason Roy.
He's a very capable batsman, and even a miss-hit shot like that goes for 4. You know, it shows his strength.
Well, at that one, quick single, and he's going to get there comfortably as David Payne gets the long barrier out. 47 for 1. Power play overs are now up, and it's been a pretty decent effort from Reigate. Bowling's been okay. Simon Eccleston very much to the fore to start with. Some powerful shots from a powerful batsman, former Somerset player. Even one-handed down the ground there. Made 17 from 14 deliveries when he picked out Simon Ridley at mid-off. It gives it a bit of an Andrew Flintoff celebration. And then Chris Murtagh, shot of the day so far, I would suggest. Good as it gets down the ground. Roy in similar fashion, looking to go straight. We've got a game here. Cockspur 2020, the first semi-final. Bournemouth 162 for 4, and Reigate hunting it down. Change of bowling. The man who took that catch, Simon Ridley, into the attack to see if he can impact the game with ball in hand. Early movement, quick single, going to have to hurry. Great bit of running there. No slouch between the wickets, either. We were talking about his fielding earlier, your younger brother, but quick between the wickets.
He is. I don't know where he's got that from either, because he's obviously got the fast genes of the family as well. He is exceptionally quick between the wickets and a brilliant fielder as well. So I think, a bit more of that to come from Reigate, hopefully. They've got to knock these ones and obviously put the bad ball away when it comes.
Oh, that was delicate. It's dicey. Short and wide. Ridley can't believe it. They did have a first slip in. It would have been straight down his throat, but asking a lot. Chris Ridley. Another pair of brothers. Hey, don't always do yourself any favours.
No, nice little shot there. Looked, we'll give him the benefit of the doubt. Looked like he guided it down to third man nicely. So that he's come in and shown good impetus here, and I think Jason Roy's the guy who's going to have to bat, you know, through the innings, and hope that Chris and obviously the other batters come in, sort of provide that impetus around him.
Slower ball, he's guided down to third man for one. Simon Ridley, an interesting character, captain Hampshire under-19s. Had a few decent players in that team. Leon Dawson down at Hampshire, played a lot of first-team cricket. Hamzar Riazuddin as well. Ridley never quite kicked on, played a little bit of Hampshire's second team. Never really kicked on, but a role to play today. That has bounced, and his younger brother Chris has missed that one, and they'll be looking for two, and they're going to get two. Running from Roy. Plenty of bounce in this wicket. Just seeing what is capable. If you hit a good area, you bend your back a bit, still plenty in this pitch.
Yeah, we had a championship game here earlier in the season on a, you know, fairly similar kind of wicket. Looked as green as this, and did plenty. But it seems to get better as, you know, as the 4 days went on. It seemed to get a better wicket to bat on.
Swing up, nice looking shot from Roy, and Chris Murtagh will want to here. He says no. But the good intensity in the running between the wickets. Yeah, talking of the wicket, I mean, we did the four-day game here between Derbyshire and Essex, and that started, although Derbyshire got 474, they probably shouldn't have done. Essex were disappointed in how they bowled. The wicket got better and better. It culminated in that Ryan Tender Scarter innings, 100 off 50 odd balls, and I think it will get better as it dries out through the day here. It'll be another single. Jason Roy not scampering this time. Just settle for the one. 57 for one. Reigate 57 for one in pursuit of 163 for victory. Tim Murtagh is going to stay with you, give you his expert opinion, but there's a change with me. Charles Colville's here.
Oakbrook and Borowish are the next sides into the fray when they take on Cuckney, and a couple of the Oakbrook boys just strolling around there, and some familiar faces as well. Kevin Dean, once of Derbyshire, not so long ago, once of Derbyshire. Matt Cassar, Derbyshire and Northants. Right, here's Simon Watkins into the attack for Bournemouth. See what he bowls. Murtagh just tickles him away for a single. 7.1 overs gone at this stage. Bournemouth 49 without loss. Reigate 58 for one. So Reigate up there at the moment. They need 105 from 77 balls to win it. Very interesting the way that Reigate are structuring this innings. Jason Roy, who has the reputation of being a master blaster, if you like, got 138 off 60-odd balls in the last round. Very watchful. Now, is that out? Is that straight down somebody's throat? It is. What a giveaway that is. Roy has just slapped a full toss straight down Longoff's throat. Denham is the catcher, and that's a bit of a blow for the Reigate Priory.
Just the last thing we needed, really. Bit of a pie, to be honest, but Roy slapped it straight down Longoff's throat. Good catch there. Reigate lose their second wicket.
Well, Jason Roy, who I thought was going to come in and just play the anchor and allow everybody to bat around him, has perished, basically. You'd have to say he's given it away, because that really was an absolutely awful delivery. Knee-high full toss, and he's just lobbed it straight down Longoff's throat. Could have hit it anywhere, and he hit it straight down Denham's throat. So anyway, he's gone. That's the end of the Roy experiment. Roy boy's gone, and we now have Michael Foster to the crease. The Australian who played a bit of great cricket, played a bit of first-class cricket in the Sheffield Shield for Victoria, was captain of the Australian under-19s, one or two years ago now, it has to be said. Was a sort of contemporary of the likes of Greg Blewett, Kaspovich, and one or two others. He was a contemporary of Gilchrist and Damian Martin, so he's from that sort of vintage. So you can understand why maybe he didn't necessarily crack the first class system. There were an awful lot of high class quality players around, but here he is now playing for Reigate.
Get on, just one!
And is a more than handy batsman. Was he around at Reigate when you were there?
He wasn't, no. No, I haven't played with Foster before, but from all accounts, you know, he's a quality player. Another one of these Aussies who come over to our leagues and score stack loads of runs.
Get on! Just one, just one!
Now, with that wicket, what does brother Chris do here? Does he have to reassess how he's going to bat? Because it looked like he was playing the dominant role and Roy was just going to sit in there and try and bat through.
Yep.
I think so, yeah. I think he'll probably have to be a bit more watchful, especially now the spinner's on. Perhaps knock it round, look to take the spinners for sort of 6 to 7 runs and over, and try and keep wickets in hand. I think wickets in hand for the last 10 overs, last 8 overs will be crucial. So I think he'll probably have to take over the Roy kind of mantle now and look to bat through the rest of the innings.
Bournemouth's point of view, of course, it's just a question of chipping away, keeping their disciplines, hurrying and harrying wherever they possibly can. Just squeezing Reigate the whole time and allowing them to self-destruct. Going to third man, just be a single. Now that's a chocolate brown helmet with a bit of sticky plaster over where I imagine the Surrey badge is. I suppose now he's off the Surrey staff. He's not allowed to wear the helmet anymore, so it's covered up for the moment.
Yeah, I think you're right. I think obviously, you know, not being on the staff anymore and not being associated with Surrey, he's probably had to cover it up. But I think he probably would have anyway. I think a few of the guys, you know, obviously haven't got Reigate helmets. And wearing their own helmet and covering up the badges.
Pulled away. Now I think that may just have the legs to go for four, will it? Yes, that's really well played by Foster. Just a bit short. From Ridley.
Yeah, nice shot there. It hasn't come off the wicket quite as he would have expected, but he's rolled his hands nicely and tucked it away for four. I think Foster's, you know, got to take on the impetus here. As I said, they've probably switched roles a little bit with Murta looking to play the anchor role.
That's out. Little nick. End of Foster. Perfectly straightforward catch, Ridley combination. Simon the bowler, Chris the catcher, and Foster the victim.
Yeah, just try to be a bit too cute there, I think. Just try to run it down off the face. Matt only succeeded in guiding it straight to the keeper. I don't think I've been much use to the Reigate boys up here. They've lost 2 wickets now while I've been here, so I might have to disappear soon.
Well, stick with us while your bro's still in. Alex Richards is the new batsman. Former Reigate Priory captained the club to 2 league titles in 2007 and 2008, so this is his first year since stepping down. Holds the club record for the highest personal score in league cricket. Score of 160 not out, so he's obviously not a mug with the bat. They need something from the former captain now. Former captain and current captain in occupation together at the crease. And that will be a wide. I have to say that I think the 17 wides that Reigate bowled in the first half of the game is quite likely to cost them very dear. You take 17 off that Bournemouth total of 162 and it's a much more manageable chase. Think about all the extra balls they had to bowl that were scored off. So really, ridiculous to bowl 17 wides. Don't know whether that was a slower ball or not, but it seemed to loop a bit outside the off stump.
Yeah, it looked like a slow ball there. He's mixing his pace well. I think obviously from the Bournemouth point of view, at this stage of the game, they want to, you know, bowl wicket to wicket, mix up their pace, make it difficult, you know, not give the Reigate boys any pace on the ball to get away to the boundary.
Bowler got very tight into the stumps and just flicked the bail off as he went past. Nine overs gone, 69 for three. Here are the three wickets that have fallen so far. First to go was Simon Eccleston, smartly taken at mid-off. Then Jason Roy, who managed to hit an absolutely dreadful delivery straight down long off throat. Never rubbish a good full toss, that's what they say in the club cricket. And then that was a perfectly straightforward, legitimate dismissal. Little nick outside the off stump. And the all Ridley combination did the rest. 69 for three, 94 to win from 66 balls. Reigate are still ahead in the run rate. They were 69 for three. Bournemouth were 67 without loss. Smart piece of keeping, and they're going to have a look at it. Richards is the man sweating now, Alex Richards. Problem, I don't think. No movement there.
No, it doesn't look like he's moved. I think the umpire's probably got a bit excited that he's got the third umpire here to play with. Just called for the extra security.
Get on!
Good, what a good finish!
Simon Watkins, the bowler, former member of the university. Centre of Cricket Excellence at Oxford. Entirely sure what he's bowling here, a mixture of this and that, a bit of the other, I suspect.
Well, that full toss seemed to work earlier. Maybe he might try a couple more of those.
Down. Yes, Payne! Get on! Keep it!
Trouble here. Oh, good throw, and I think Murta might have been struggling.
Never struggling. There's that pace I spoke about. Would have been comfortably home.
Go on, I finish! Get on!
10 overs gone. It's the halfway stage. 72 for three. Mark House is the new bowler.
Oh, oh.
Little bit of a misfield. So Mark House in with a terrific opportunity, nick a couple of wickets out here, and he's a certain man of the match after his brilliant innings in the first half. Little low slung medium pacer just coming in, no bounce at all, skidding the ball on.
Yeah.
And that's out. Would you believe it? Another full toss, I think that is, has claimed another victim. And Reigate are beginning to sink here.
Yeah, the end of Murta. As you said, another one of those low full tosses, which he's towed quite nicely straight to mid-wicket. You know, a big wicket for Bournemouth. Chris, you know, is gutted. Perhaps should have put that in the seats, as you said, Charles.
Easy from up here, mind, isn't it? 25 off 20 balls for the captain, Chris Murta. He's gone. And at 73 for four, Reigate have got a lot of work to do. They need 90 from 58 with six wickets in hand.
Yes.
Well, what a day this is turning out to be for Mark House. Jonathan Gale is the new batsman.
Yo!
House is a man in a hurry. He's sprinting back to his mark after every ball bowled.
Stop!
How a little inside edge is there, or is that just straight through to the keeper? Whatever it is, it's causing problems. So House is not a regular bowler, I understand, for Bournemouth. Doesn't necessarily bowl every time. It's just causing problems. It's his day at the moment.
It is. You know, he batted very well. And obviously, he's picked up that crucial wicket of Murta and looks to be in a nice rhythm.
A little bit of inswing there. Just outside the line of off stump. Not out. Very, very close. It was certainly pad bat. It was pad first, just outside the line of off stump, though. Good decision.
You're down!
Definitely tailing the ball in.
Definitely, yeah, as you said, a little bit of drift into the right-handers and a great over.
One run, one wicket, four dots. Brilliant stuff by House, and I would say this game is now swinging very much Bournemouth's way. .90/9. Even with my appalling maths, I can work out that's a straight 10 and over. Who's going to get these runs? Watkins starting his third.
Yeah!
And there's another one. Like lemmings going over the cliff, the llamas are in trouble.
Oh dear, another bit of, yeah, good bit of bowling by the off spinner. He's tossed it up, drawn Richards down the wicket, and he's slapped this one straight to extra cover as well. So the Reigate batsmen are not covering themselves in glory here.
Do you think he is bowling off spin, or is there a bit of wrist spin in there as well? I can't quite work it out.
Looks like off spin from here. I might be wrong. He might bowl the doozer, though. You never know. It might be one of these unusual actions that, you know, is difficult to pick up for the batsman. Obviously, the Reigate batsmen have struggled with him, and he's picked up a couple of crucial wickets.
He has, hasn't he? That's definitely an off-spinner's action. Matt Bennett is the new batsman, kept wicket for Reigate Priory. And, he needs to produce something special here. Both batsmen on naught, an ideal situation for Bournemouth. They got two batsmen on naught. Gale, who's only faced four balls. Here's Bennett facing his first. And inevitably, there is a tenseness and a nervousness about the Reigate batting now.
Yeah, Bennett's still a good player, so there's still hope. But, you know, as you said, it's looking like a tough task for the Reigate batsmen to knock off these runs. But they do bat a long way down, and they definitely won't give up hope.
Well, Bournemouth are looking very well drilled now. I think the difference between the two sides is going to be the extras and the little fumbles in the field. There were so many when Reigate bowled, and there is just a lot more discipline, a lot more focus. They look a lot more professional here, these Bournemouth boys, at the moment.
They do. I think, you know, looking back on the game, if Reigate do go on to lose it, that will be the area that they'll target.
Swan!
Only the single. Indecision again when it came to the batting, a little bit of a slip as well. 12 overs gone, 74 for 5. The asking rate climbs and climbs. It's 89 from 48 is the equation. Original rate 8.15. It's now up to over 11. Last three overs, 5 for 2. Here comes House to bowl his second over. Well, eventually it's a wide. Just the single. Mark House jogs back to his mark to bowl from. Sure, he's got much of a future as a first-class bowler. He'd be absolutely exhausted after a morning at Lord's, wouldn't he, doing this?
He would, yeah. They're obviously behind the rate, you know, as regards time here. He hasn't got that much of a run-up, though, so he looks a fit lad. Not sure I could do this, but, yeah, as I said, he's not far to run in.
Amongst your many claims to fame was that famous bowl out against Warwickshire in the 2020 Cup when you managed to hit the stumps, which nobody else seemed able to do. Still live on with you as a great memory. Wide down the leg side, and I think that'll be 4. Keeper hasn't been able to collect cleanly.
It was. It's, you know, it still is up there with, you know, my top probably 2 or 3 moments in cricket. The whole kind of roller coaster of the day, going from thinking that we'd won the game to then being told that we had to come out and do a bowl out. Me hitting the final stump, taking my shirt off like a lunatic and running around the oval is a bit that I tried to forget about.
Just won!
Little in drift again. I was going to ask you about that, because that is always the other memory, you doing the circuit of the oval bare-chested, setting all those hearts aflutter in the stands. That was in the Surrey committee room.
Yeah, I think those were the only hearts that were fluttering. Not very fluttering pictures came out of that event. And I'm pretty sure I won't do that again now.
Only other time I've seen that done on a cricket field. Actually, another player who's here today did it. It was Kevin Dean of Derbyshire. It was against Leicestershire. He had chickenpox at the time, so it was a pretty unpleasant sight all round. Good stop. Brilliant stop. Bournemouth are on top here, no doubt about it. 13 overs gone. It's 85 for 5. Seven to go, 78 needed from 42 if Reigate Priory are going to make the final. It looks like Bournemouth at the moment. Tim Murta has left. John Morris is moved into his seat. No bare-chested heroics from you at any stage, John.
Oh, goodness me, they haven't got a bra big enough for me, I'm afraid, these days. However, moving on swiftly. Bournemouth. Certainly in the driving seat, you're dead right.
I
said
it
in the break that it was going to be a lot of runs to get, and it would appear to be the case. They've played some very good cricket here. They've not been overawed at all. Stuck to the disciplines, and that's why they're in the position they're in.
Well, here's Watkins in his final over. He's got another 4 balls to bowl. His figures are outstanding, 2 for 10.
It doesn't come much better than that, to be honest, in 2020 cricket. He's kept it tight and picked up a couple of wickets.
He's bowled it really slowly, hasn't he? That's the thing. And he's just challenged the batsmen, and they haven't been up to it. At the other end, House has been bowling these really slow little seamers. two overs, no maidens, one for 12. There's another really slow delivery. It's going to be given a wide, which is a bit harsh, perhaps, but that's the name of the game.
Well, as long as these umpires are consistent, which they have been, and they've been really good at that, so no problem from me that at all.
Get on, just one, the card.
Now, Watkins' figures in 2020 cricket, as I say, they don't come much better than that. You know, the rate's going up all the time. It's nearly 12 and over now. So it's going to be an awful lot for Reigate to do. They've just got to keep the cool here, Bournemouth, and they'll win this game.
Great work here, 1-0. Great work, Matt.
I've just been looking at Watkins's array of nicknames.
Oh, yes.
Well, bold. He's known either as Watto, that's imaginative, Fox, or Spike. And I was just trying to work out where Spike came from. And I know he reminds me of, do you remember in Notting Hill, the Welsh lad in Notting Hill who played the character Spike? He looks just like him.
He's not dissimilar. Reese somebody, I can't remember his surname.
Ifan, something like that. Anyway, he's bowled out. He's done a very good job. Notting Hill look-alike or not. 2 for 12. That, let's face it, was not the greatest delivery he's ever bowled in his life, but it brought about the end of Jason Roy. And then a well-flighted off-spinner, smartly taken at short extra. And he finishes with figures of 4 overs, no maidens, 2 for 12. And if Bournemouth make it through to the final, he's played a major part in that.
Amazing figures, great stuff for his team. It's amazing how many times bad balls get wickets, isn't it? Low full toss, hit it straight down Longoff's throat. But it says in the book, out. That's the most important thing. Bournemouth, well, we said earlier on that they were terrified playing in front of the cameras, in front of a crowd in this big occasion. But they've stood up so far, let's hope they can finish the job off.
Well, they've looked the better side, haven't they? They've batted coolly and calmly and efficiently. They've taken their opportunities. They've been very disciplined in their batting. And they're even more disciplined in their bowling as well. And their fielding has been first class, given away very few second runs with sloppy misfields, which I'm afraid to say was certainly a feature of the Reigate effort in the field.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. As I said again, you know, it's all about doing the simple things well in 2020 cricket. They built a partnership, House and Park, at the start, 100 partnership, put pressure on the Reigate team right from the outset, and the Reigate team did not stand up to that. There was too many wides, too many extras, and it's costing them. That's what's happened here in this game, and in condensed cricket like this is you have to be disciplined.
Pulled away, but it's only going to be a single. And they need fours now. They need fours and sixes.
Well, the rate's creeping up all the time. 13 and a half nearly now. So, you know, I'm really pleased because, you know, this is the young team in this competition. There are four teams here. These are, without any shadow of a doubt, the youngest here. Lack of experience, you can say all the things, but they've had the enthusiasm and the belief, I believe, to get them into this position. That's the most important thing.
Couple on here, certainly. Now, in a moment or two, if everything goes according to plan, we should have the toss for the second semi-final, which is Cookney versus Opbrook and Borrowash. Again, that in-swing can only get it away for a single. So 15 overs gone, 95 for 5. Let's go and join Ian Harvey for that toss.
Thanks, Charles. We've got the two captains here for the second semi-final. Will, you've got the... No, Neil, you've got the coin for the toss. So, when you're ready, buddy. Heads is the call. And it looks like a head to me.
We can have a bat, mate.
So, Will, you've won the toss.
Yeah.
Have you seen anything out here, mate, that might indicate why you've decided to bat first?
We've just sort of batted first all through the competition. Didn't really want to change too much. The lads are confident doing that, so we're just going to stick with what's been working for us, really.
Cool, bud. Thanks. Good luck for today.
Thank you.
You're happy to...
Have a bowl?
Yeah, you're happy to have a bowl,
mate? Yeah, pretty much. I think we'd have been happy doing either, to be honest, but, you know, we're not disappointed to be bowling. It looks like it's green. It's still nibbling around a bit even this late in the game, so, yeah, we're pretty happy with that.
All right, mate. Good luck today. And we'll head back upstairs to you, Charles.
Thank you, Ian. So Cookney have won the toss and they're going to bat first in that second semi-final, which is going to start, I should think, probably in about 20 minutes' time or so, once this game is done and dusted. We'll then have a little break as the two sides switch over, and then we'll be straight into the second semi-final. Games coming thick and fast here on Club 2020 Finals Day. Pete Smith is the new bowler. Going from the old grandstand end of the ground. Another Bournemouth bowler who likes to run back to his mark.
They're full of enthusiasm. That's what I've loved about this team right from the outset. As soon as they got here this morning, they were up for it. The first boundary of the day was hit in the second over. And the whole team stood up off the bench and applauded it. It was great to see, and they really got behind their team right from the outset. And when you're a coach, which I am here at Derbyshire, that's what you want to see. You want to see that enthusiasm, that belief in your team. And I'm really pleased for this Bournemouth team because they're the youngest team, and I've said it right from the outset, if they stand up and be counted as a young team, how good is that for the game?
66 needed from 27 balls. Surely this game is over as a contest. Fours and sixes are missing. We've only had 8 fours and 1 6, and that's the problem. No boundaries means no big score, no quick scoring, means exit from the competition for the Reigate Priory side.
Does that upset you, Charles? Surrey, I know you're Surrey through and through. It's a Surrey team. Come on, be honest with me.
I'll let you know in 4 overs and 2 balls.
Take that as a yes, then.
I've really enjoyed watching this Bournemouth side. I think they're really well drilled, and I think that's so encouraging. Quite often, when you commentate and spend your whole life watching professional cricket, and there are former professional cricketers who get a bit sort of sniffy about club cricket. Well, I think I've seen performances by professional sides which have been worse than this by Bournemouth.
Absolutely. I wouldn't disagree with you at all there. I think they've been really disciplined. They've kept at their guns. It's just the enthusiasm for me from them. You know, you can get a bit cynical towards club cricket at times as a professional. I think this is absolutely brilliant for the game.
100 for 5 after 16. So 4 overs to go, 63 needed from 24. If they're going to win it, it'll be spectacular. And here to talk you through, Dave Fulton joining John Morris.
Thanks, Charles. And that's going to run away. Be at least a brace. Probably all it's going to be.
Byers as well, so it's been unfortunate for the keeper. So he's had a good game here, House. 65 not out with the bat. Played brilliantly at the top of the order, and he's having a good little bowl here as well. 3.1 overs, 1 for 18 so far, so a man of the match stakes even there.
It's a good-looking shot. Just didn't quite get hold of it, dropping short of long off. James Park doing the tidying up. Scampering back to his mark, Mark House. Be keen to get on with it. Won't be too many celebrations, I wouldn't have thought, if they do win this one. Final coming up.
Well, that's big. That's out of here. 6 all the way. As soon as it left the bat, just drifted into the middle of the bat. Started a little bit too straight. Heading towards that leg stump, and he's whacked it over long mid-wicket, really. It's a super shot.
Well, is there a twist? We haven't seen the best of Reigate Priory. The Lamas haven't been doing their celebratory dance. But more shots like that, this could be a contest again. Looked high. Umpires looking at each other. That to be a no ball. Not being signalled. No, it is a no ball. Yes, yeah, still a bit of conferring between the umpires and a no ball. Not a front foot no ball, so there will be no free hit.
Good umpire in there. Took the time, didn't panic about it. Had a chat with each other. Called it right. Very good.
Just a single. Just wonder with this Mark House just drifting the ball in with that slog sweep. Get your front pad outside off stumps. You can't be out LBW. Get your weight across and then aim for that mid-wicket area. Running it down a third man is not going to do you any good.
Well, that's certainly the area I've been targeting, that's for certain.
Pull that. It's up in the air. This could be out. Yeah! Pete Smith underneath it. And Bournemouth are on the brink here. Another one goes down. 111 for 6 now.
Well, there's another great wicket here for the House. And a big shot. It's gone straight down the ground. well taken. Absolutely kept his eyes on it on the run. And how pleased is he about that? 111 for six.
Disappointment for Matt Bennett. Tried to repeat the dose, really. The first one was almost a slog sweep. He's being clapped off by his supporters. But they'll be disappointed in what they've seen from their team. The nerves that got the better of them early. Coming back to haunt them. But he doesn't matter. He doesn't mind. Mark House, he's having one hell of a game. Good-looking shot. Going to run away for four. They're not going to die wandering here, Reigate. It's the right way to go. You're going to go down in flames. Lots of shots required. Simon King is the new batsman. Surrey off-spinner. Played a handful of first-class matches, or one-day appearances, I should say, for Surrey.
Played a first-class game against Derbyshire earlier on this year. At Whitgift School. Bowled okay. On a turning pitch, he kept quite tight. He bowled good lines. But he's got a lot to do now, to tell you. Said at half-time, it's a lot of runs, 160. A lot of runs to get, and especially on this pitch, it always nibbles around. And if you pick wickets up in 2020 cricket, the pressure just keeps building. I mean, the rate's over 16 now, so, you know, it's an awful long way away for them.
All hinging on this man, Jonathan Gale. Can he work a miracle? It's a good-looking strike. He's got it straight down the ground. Going to come back for two. Simon King's quick. Yeah, Bournemouth have just done the basics, haven't they? They bowled nicely, they fielded really well, they stuck to their plans. And there's been just enough in the pitch to make batting a tricky business.
Well, I think Reigate let themselves down in the first four or five overs. The pressure went on to them. They couldn't control the pink ball. There was too many wides, too many extras, extra balls to score off. They didn't pick up wickets. And consequently, they've struggled since. However,
got a hold of that one.
What a shot that,
that
is, by the
could
way.
Could have gone all the way. The signal is four. Might want to have just a second look at this because this is borderline six, and if this does go down to the wire, you don't want to get this wrong. Another great shot from Gale.
He's just backed away, punched it over deep cover. It's inside the rope. Look at that. It's got a bit of a kink in it. If it was been straighter around there, it'd have been six. Small margins in sport, eh?
Nudge the rope in the dugout there. Got hold of this one as well. It's up in the air. This could be out. It's a towering catch. And he's missed it, and he's gone for four. Ed Denham in the field, bit of a blip, and there's still belief on that Reigate bench.
Well, it's certainly the highest of the day. That's gone miles up. Pleased I wasn't underneath it, that's for certain. It's gone over him, one bounce four. And as you say, is there a little twist? Well, it's a tall order, we know, but however, it's been done before, and it'll be done again.
It's a better length. Dug it out. It's going to be the single this time. And you kind of feel that Gale's got to get on strike as much as he can. And this is the emphasis, a new batter. What would you be saying to one of your young batsmen if you're pushing them out there?
Absolutely that. Just get him on strike as much as you possibly can. He's 27 not out of 26 balls. He's the man in. You're not going to come in and middle the first ball. Well, I suppose you can do, but, you know, he's the man on form, really. So get him on strike as much as you possibly can.
He's just nicked the strike, but got to take every run that's on offer as well. It's a catch 22, isn't it? As much as you want Gale to be on strike, you're not going to turn a run down.
In this condensed game, 20 over cricket, you have to take your singles. But sometimes the boundaries, people go too hard for boundaries sometimes. And that's when you lose your wickets, you're trying to push it so hard to get that big total that wins you the game. Instead of just keeping the basics, rotate the strike, and the bad ball comes, make sure you put it away. And if you've got the basis there, then you can go for your big shots.
34 runs to win from 12 balls, 17 and over. Jonathan Gale is a powerful man, and he's 27 not out. Simon King needs to get him on strike. It's Graham Wagg. Had a pretty good week. Finished on the losing side, but it's impressive for the boys. Had a good season for you.
He's an impressive cricketer. He's full of action cricketer. Bats, bowls, fields, does the lot. You know, he's a super kid as well. Works hard at his game. We're pleased to have him here at Derby.
They're going to scamper. Oh, it's going to be run out, is it? He gets back. Good bit of bowling. David Payne back into the attack, and he's found the Yorker straight away.
He's a proud dad as well. It's his young man's birthday today, Braden. He's one today, so it's his little birthday party up here at the club, so that's nice. I think the lads are coming down to have a drink, I think, as well. Just any excuse, as they say. Long way to go, though, here. Bournemouth, they're in the driving seat. Required right now, well, it's 18.55.
It's a meaty looking blow, though. It's just going to be the single, but it does get Gale back on strike. And you'd rather feel that he's going to have to go big this over. You don't want to leave too much to do off the last.
Well, there is a lot to do, full stop now. 33 off 10 balls. Awful long way away for Reigate now. There's got to be a miracle for me. There's got to be three or four good hits here in this over. Sixes. Get them anywhere near for the last over.
It's a good-looking shot over extra cover. This could go all the way, you know. And it has. It's a lovely shot inside out over extra cover. Jonathan Gale playing a fine hand here.
Well, he's certainly not given up, has he? In his mind, he can still win this for them. Super shot over extra cover. Well, quality shot. Mark War, he was one of the best of that I've seen. Opening the face and hitting it over cover.
What I like about it is he's not just slogging. A lot of runs, but proper cricket shots, lots of composure.
As we said earlier, again, it's about the basics of the game. Keep the basics simple, the proper techniques in the shot, hit down the ground, pick your gaps in the field, and boundaries will come from that. When you try and hit the ball too hard and you look at poor areas to score, target the area and stick with the shape of the shot. It works 9 times out of 10.
Simon King has picked that up and it has gone for 6. And there could be a little sting in this Reigate Priory tail.
What a shot that is. As soon as it left the middle of the bat, it was always going to go for 6. Giving himself a bit of depth in the crease and his hands free and puts it straight through the line of the ball. Picked it up over deep square. Fantastic shot. He's gone miles, that has.
Can he repeat the dose? In the slot, and he's whacked that over extra cover. Fielder might just get to it. Does so. They'll come back for 2. Another quality cricket shot. They can't do much about it there at the minute. Most of those men are out. Michael Foster, Matt Bennett.
How you like a little tipple, David? Where's your money?
Well, 20 runs to win, you've got to say Bournemouth, but it's not a great time to bowl a no ball, is it?
Well, pressure's on again now to Bournemouth a little bit. 1 over to go, 20 required. Ed Denham to bowl this final over. 20 from 6 balls. Well, Bournemouth are in the driving seat. Oh, that's a great start. Only a single off it, or should be only be a single off it. Looking for 2, but it's not there. That's brilliant.
Yeah, I just wonder whether Simon King had to come back there, although he's seen that he's a pretty powerful striker. Just getting Jonathan Gale back on strike, taking a gamble on a misfield. Got to get your man who's in back on strike if you can.
Totally agree. That's the time where you look at the board and you say, what have I got to do to win this game? And if it means giving you your own wicket up, then that's what you have to do sometimes.
It's going to be a single. This is looking a very tall order now. Pretty decent day, the captain, Craig de Veerman. Final was within touching distance, just need a bit of composure in the field and Ed Denham to do the basics with the ball. Smacked it away to mid-wicket. It was an interesting option from Denham to bang the ball in, and he got away with it.
Well, it's a great over. It's a great over so far, only 3 singles off 3 balls. Three balls left to go, 17 required. Well, it's very straightforward now. Sixes are required.
This would be a great story for Simon King. It's going to be a hero, young man. What a good bit of bowling that is. 72.8 miles an hour, but it wasn't what he was expecting. He's giving it a wide. Now, that's controversial. It looked like a pretty decent bumper to me.
Well, I'm sorry, but that is just wrong. There's nothing wrong with this delivery whatsoever. It's not overhead height. It's gone over his shoulder, underneath the length of the helmet, and he's crouching down when he's gone for it. And it's gone inside the body. So how that can be a wide, I do not know. I'm sorry, but that's not correct.
Justice for the bowler. What I was going to say was at least it keeps the game alive. It's not really the umpire's job, but struggling now. They're barring a disaster and a no ball. Oh, lots of lightning running between the wickets. It looks like it's going to be Bournemouth's game. It'll be the second side from the Southern Premier League to reach the final of this competition. Tottenham kneeling the other. And a play and a miss. Bournemouth doing it in style here.
Well, it's all over, obviously. You know, I think they deserve this. They've played really good cricket, this young Bournemouth team. I was really pleased for them because, as I said, last night they were nervous. They were talking about it, you know, in the bar. They were saying how what a big event it is for them. The average age is 20, and they've come out and really performed, and I'm delighted for them. Take nothing away from Reigate. They've put their show on as well, but unfortunately on the day, Bournemouth have been the team.
Got hold of this one. And it's going to be out, and they finish it in some style. James Park celebrates, as do their supporters. Bournemouth, worthy finalists. They've won in some style here. They win by 15 runs, and aren't they happy about it? They'll have to calm down, get a bit of composure, regroup, ready for the final. But Ed Denham has deserved this. He bowled a really fine last over. Simon King had nothing to lose. The Bananas are happy. And Bournemouth are happy. Just can't help but think those extras were the key. 17 wides. When you lose by 15 runs and you've given 17 wides, you've only really got yourselves to blame. But they played a fine hand trying to chase the runs down. They're going to be gutted, Reigate Priory. Losing is one thing, but they didn't put their A game out there. And they will be disappointed. But those young men, and it is a young side, average age of 20, great experience for them, and worthy winners. Cockspur 2020 played in great spirit. Lots of firm handshakes there, and congratulations all round to the winning side. That's good to see. Reigate Priory, they were much fancied before this competition, expected to win this semi-final. They bow out at the semi-final stage. This is the story of the second half of this match from the batting perspective. Jason Roy 11 from 16, Simon Eccleston a meaty 17 from 14, and Chris Murtagh might have played the shot of the day with that straight 6, 25 from 20. Small contributions from Foster and Richards, and then Jonathan Gale. It was in vain in the end, but he showed what he was capable of. The all-rounder, 34 from 30. Matt Bennett, 16 from 18. And Simon King, the last wicket to fall, 11 from 10, as they finished 147 for 7. And all these bowlers acquitted themselves really well. David Payne played for Gloucestershire yesterday in the Pro 40. 35 off his 4. Ed Denham, 2 for 29. There was a brace of wickets for Watkins and for House, who had a fine all-round game. They acquitted themselves really well. Bournemouth 162 for 4, and Reigate couldn't quite get there. 147 for 7. Bournemouth are through to the final. They've won by 15. And we'll go down. Ian Harvey has the captains with him.
Yeah, thank you very much. I've got the two captains alongside me here. And Chris, bad luck, buddy. Do you think those first five overs may have cost you the game?
Yeah, I think... Well, we bowled too many extras today. Didn't field all that well. Lost wickets at the wrong time. But other than that, we played pretty well.
Yeah, it got pretty tight towards the end. Did you still think you had a chance with the last few overs?
yeah, you always think you've got a chance. But credit to Bournemouth, you know, they deserved it today, and I'd like to wish them good luck in the final.
Thanks, buddy. And Craig, well done, buddy. Congratulations. It was a good win. Good all-round performance, bat and ball. Got runs on the board, and then the bowlers backed it up.
Yeah, that was the plan, really. We wanted to try and get the runs on the board and then defend it. We know we're strong in the field. We're not really a team of many superstars. We just work well as a unit and field hard and make sure we put it in the right areas, and I think we did that today.
Yeah, and any changes for this afternoon? Did you learn much from that game on the wicket? I mean, I know you bowled second there. Would you think of changing that around for the final?
Yeah, well, you know, we have learnt things from the wicket and the pitch, and you know, we've got other players in the locker, so you know, we'll look hard at it and have a good think about it, and I'm sure whatever we go with, the boys will come up with the goods.
Thanks very much, buddy. Well played, and good luck this afternoon.
Can be very popular, isn't he, if he drops one of those semi-finalists and brings in a new player for the final. That really won't go down very well. There'll be a lot of kicking of something or other by whichever poor soul got left out. Anyway, those are the harsh decisions a captain and doubtless his manager will have to make. Right, we're going to take a quick break. When we come back, it'll be the second semi-final we'll be concentrating on. It's a Cuckney from the Notts League, the Notts Premier, against the mighty Otbrook and Borough-Wash, who are the kings of the Derby Premier. So, build up to that is coming very shortly.